The Cool Hit Sports Network and Cool TV proudly presents Kentucky Christian University Football. This KCU football game is brought to you in part by Clark's Pump and Shops of the Tri-State, Stultz Pharmacy in Greenup, and McDonald Pharmacy in South Shore, Members' Choice Credit Union, First National Bank of Grayson and Cannonsburg, Trey Hermanos Nunez Mexican Restaurant, River Cities Builders, A&A Porta Potties, and Kentucky Christian University. Now, let's go to the field for the pregame show as the Cool Hit Sports Network and Cool TV presents exciting Kentucky Christian University football.
The KCU football here on the Cool Hit Sports Network. I'm Chauncey Griffith, and I'm joined by Mr. Coach Brent Terry. And we're so glad to have you along here from Grayson. A beautiful day for college football here in Grayson, Kentucky. The KCU Knights come into this one at 1-6. This is a conference game, an AAC football game. They're playing a familiar opponent, the St. Andrews Knights. So we have the Knights versus the Knights, and there's a traveling trophy. We'll talk more about that here in a few minutes. But a little bit of added motivation, I guess, Coach, something to play for. Traveling trophy, and I know talking with Coach Russell on the Coach Russell program here on the Cool Hit Sports Network, that's something that's a little bit of bragging rights. That's something they want back.
Yeah, absolutely. Both teams, I'm sure, excited to get to play today. It's a beautiful day here in Grayson. It's a great day for football. You got both teams coming in with identical records. Both teams, you know, feeling like they've got a good shot to win this game. You know, the season hasn't gone, not as many wins as each team would like. So when you get a comparable opponent like this, everybody gets excited, and you feel like you got a good chance to win the football game. So we're looking forward to an exciting game today.
Yeah, no doubt about it. We said beautiful weather. Good crowd here in Grayson. It's good to be back at home, and really looking forward to bringing you all the action here from Grayson today. We're going to step out, take our first break of the pregame show, and when we come back, we will have a word from KCU head football coach Jake Russell. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
You know, financial security begins at home with home ownership. If you've been putting off looking for a home because you think you can't afford it, you owe it to yourself to check out Members' Choice Credit Union. Members' Choice Credit Union has programs for first-time homebuyers and more to help put you in the home of your dreams. Call, click, or stop by Members' Choice Credit Union today.
Members' Choice Credit Union, NMLS 411-945, Equal Housing Lender. Call for additional information. Other restrictions may apply.
In addition to the Greenup location, Stultz Pharmacy's newest location is at 437 James Hanna Drive in South Shore, but has retained the name you know and love, McDonald Pharmacy, with the same great service you'll find in the Greenup location, with free delivery service and their convenient drive-through. Get your vaccinations and allergy shots, and of course, great prescription service. At Stultz Pharmacy in Greenup and McDonald Pharmacy, James Hanna Drive, South Shore.
Stultz Pharmacy.
Uncle Rick, what are you doing?
I'm trying to stay cooler in my man cave.
Well, this is a beer cave, and you can't stay in this cooler forever.
But Clark's Pub and Shop can get you through the dog days of summer.
Whether it's fountain drinks at the lowest price or you're filling up the cooler for the family and friends, Clark's has the widest selection, the best prices, and the most helpful staff you'll find anywhere.
Beat the heat at Clark's Pub and Shop.
Return, refresh, refuel.
When you want real, authentic Mexican menu items, you want Tres Hermanos Nunez. Accept no substitutes. None compares. Fajitas, tacos, burritos, quesadillas, chimichangas, even vegetarian choices. A kid's menu, desserts, and salads, a tasty, budget-pleasing selection for you and your family, unlike any others, should be your first and only choice for authentic Mexican all throughout the tri-state. Ashland, Greenup, Grayson, Paintsville, Canova, South Point, Olive Hill, and Cannonsburg. Tres Hermanos Nunez, the best around.
Back in Grayson, we're now joined by KCU head coach Jake Russell. Coach, thanks for giving us a little time.
Absolutely. Beautiful day. Excited to have our first home game in a while.
Yeah, that's what I was going to bring up. How does it feel to be back at home?
It feels great. You know, being able to wake up in your own bed, all the players the same way. You know, that's just a benefit in itself. You know, like we talked about on the show, you know, them having to travel 7 or 8 hours, staying in a hotel, you know, it's not an easy thing to do. But we've got to take advantage of it. They're still playing the same game no matter where you play it, and we've still got to come out and be disciplined, be physical to win this game today.
a familiar opponent. We, like you said, we talked about it on the show. What do you know about the opponent today?
Yeah, I mean, they're very talented. They've got some really good players that we played against last year. They're a team that's coming off their first win. You know, they're trying to do the same thing we are, which is, you know, make a really good run here to end the season and build something for the future. You know, Coach is in his first season over there, and he's in the process of changing that culture. You know, but they're hungry for a win just like we are. And, you know, both teams think they can get a win today, which is, you know, always a dangerous thing.
Should prove for some good football.
Yeah, I think it'll be a really competitive game. I think if we come out and just execute in all three phases of the game, we're going to be really successful today. But we also got to win one-on-one matchups when you go against a team that does have talent. And, you know, again, that comes through great preparation, which I think we've had through our bye week and through this week.
You kind of hit on it there. What are the keys to a win?
Yeah, protecting the football, as always. I think we've done a really, really good job of that the last couple games, starting there with Union, Max specifically at the quarterback position. You know, not having, you know, not just interceptions, but the bad interceptions. You know, interception here or there, that's going to come naturally when you're playing aggressively, when you're calling the game aggressively.
Yeah.
But just not having the bad, and that's part of his maturing process as a young quarterback who's still, you know, halfway into, you know, starting his first season. And then our defense getting turnovers. They've done a great job all year. You know, that was one thing against Reinhardt. We were probably that one big or two turnovers away on that defensive side from having a chance, you know, to cut that thing to one score in the fourth quarter. And that's something we're going to try to do today is, you know, create turnovers in special teams and defense and not have them on the offensive side.
Sounds like a plan, Coach. Go Knights.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
Appreciate it.
Need some extra money for home improvements or other purchases? How about a home equity line of credit with absolutely no closing costs? We have some exciting news from our loan department at First National Bank. Right now, open a home equity line of credit at First National and we will pay all the fees at closing. Hurry into one of our 8 locations to take advantage of this great offer. First National Bank, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC.
Does your gas station or convenience store need a facelift? If so, call River City Builders at 473-4112 for your remedy. Big or small projects, River City's Builders is a company for all your needs. We have extensive experience in the petroleum industry, from routine gas dispenser and canopy maintenance to above-ground, underground tank and piping work to full-blown remodels and new builds. Call River City Builders at 473-4112 for all your petroleum needs. We'll cover your back and keep your customers pumping gas.
When you have business away from home or a planned event far from your comfort zone, you're probably going to need a little help. Let A&A Porta Potties assist you with all your portable toilet needs. Whether on a construction site, planning for an outdoor wedding, or any other outdoor event, A&A Porta Potties are here to assist you. A&A Porta Potties also rents out storage containers, office containers, cooling fans, tables, and chairs. A&A Porta Potties, there is no event too big or too small for us to accommodate you.
Kentucky Christian University is a private, nonprofit university located in the beautiful foothills of eastern Kentucky. KCU offers both undergraduate and graduate programs, including the new Teacher Leader Master of Arts in Education degree. They also have an array of competitive sports. Kentucky Christian University is committed to focusing on Christ while helping students build character and prepare for their future careers. Visit kcu.edu to learn more or to schedule a visit on campus.
And welcome back to Grayson, Kentucky. Chauncey Griffith, Brent Terry, glad to have you along. And Coach Terry, here in the pregame show, we watched him warm up. What are your thoughts here just early on?
Well, you know, it's very difficult to tell, you know, much about a team just from warm-ups. You
sure.
Can see a little bit. But, you know, trying to see were the guys ready to play or not. A long time ago, you know, forgot about trying to figure out who was ready to play and who wasn't ready to play based on warm-ups. Yet, you know, some guys are happy and cheering and smiling and very loose, and other guys are, you know, ready to bang their head off the goalpost.
That's
and,
right.
You know, and they both and both can be ready in their different ways. So it's just tough to learn much about that. But, you know, just kind of looking at some of the statistics, some of the keys as we go into this game, you know, it's I think – Kentucky Christian goes as their quarterback goes, Maxwell Ward. You know, he's putting together a nice season. Statistics can continue to improve as we've gone throughout the year, and as Coach talked about in the pregame show, you know, he's trying to eliminate some of those bad interceptions that plagued him early on, take care of the ball, and they've done that better the last few games. You know, he's completing nearly 55% of his passes, and that number's continued to rise throughout the year.
Right.
You know, 13 touchdowns against 9 interceptions and they're working on that ratio as they go on. And so I expect Max to have a big game today. And I think he's going to have a big game for them to win. He's kind of the starting point for this offense. But I'm sure they'd like to get the running game going a little bit too.
Absolutely.
You look down, you'd certainly like to see Josh Taylor and, you know, Devontae Williams and those guys have some rushing yards today. And, we're only rushing for about 103 yards a game this year and definitely throwing the ball for nearly 250 a game. So it'd be nice to maybe, be able to get the running game going a little bit, take a little bit of the pressure off of Max and make him even more successful maybe.
Now defensively, what can you say about defense?
Well, on
because, the reason I bring that up now is because you're talking about, I guess, keys to victory.
Mm-hmm.
And the KCU defense has been a key all year long. They've been pretty solid.
Yeah, they are giving up about 430 yards a game, but they've played some very tough opponents.
That's the thing, yeah.
That's right. They've played some very tough opponents, giving up 36 a game. But you look over on the other side of the ball, St. Andrew's offense has not been nearly as prolific as some of the other offenses that they've seen this year. They're only rushing the ball for about 113 a game and throwing it for 142, a total of 256 a game. That's nowhere near what some of the other opponents have done. They're only scoring 10 points a game, so it's going to be important for the KCU defense to kind of hold them around that average today.
Mm-hmm.
If they can hold them around that 10, 13, 14, keep them around their scoring average, I think that would certainly bode well for the Knights. For our Knights.
the ones from Grayson, right?
That's right. Both teams with the nickname of the Knights. So hopefully don't make that mistake too often. They have to call them Kentucky Christian and St. Andrews.
Now, as a coach, we talk about the Knights versus the Knights, and there's a traveling trophy, and obviously that's something you want at your campus, not the other one. Is that something you focus on for motivation as a coach?
Probably not too much right now. You want the trophy, and it'll be something you can rally around a little bit. But, honestly, I don't think that's a big focal point of what's going on. They're going to be more concerned about executing, the game plan, trying to take care of the football. They're worried about those things more than, who's got the trophy right now. And that's something maybe for after the game you can celebrate.
Sure.
You put it up in the locker room and you show the recruits and, all that kind of stuff. And it is good to have that. But as far as, right now, both teams are trying to get their second win. That's going to be their focus.
That's right. And those of you watching at home, we see the coin toss. It looks like KCU will have the football first. So we'll get an early look at that offense that we're talking about and looking forward to that. Hey, we're going to step out. We've got one more break to get in here in the pregame show. But when we get back, it's time for football. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
Financial security begins at home with home ownership. If you've been putting off looking for a home because you think you can't afford it, you owe it to yourself to check out Members Choice Credit Union. Members Choice Credit Union has programs for first-time homebuyers and more to help put you in the home of your dreams. Call, click, or stop by Members Choice Credit Union today.
Members Choice Credit Union, NMLS 411-945, Equal Housing Lender. Call for additional information. Other restrictions may apply.
In addition to the Greenup location, Stelz Pharmacy's newest location is at 437 James Hanna Drive in South Shore, but has retained the name you know and love, McDonald Pharmacy, with the same great service you'll find in the Greenup location, with free delivery service and their convenient drive-thru. Get your vaccinations and allergy shots, and of course, great prescription service. At Stelz Pharmacy in Greenup and McDonald Pharmacy, James Hanna Drive, South Shore.
Stelz Pharmacy.
And we're back here in Grayson. Coach, it's time for football. Casey, you starting out with football. How big would it be to get a score here early on?
Well, certainly you want to try to establish your offense, because if you can get the running game going a little bit, take it down. You always like to play from position of the lead. Everybody likes to do that. So it'd be big for KCU to execute their first drive, get a little confidence, and take the thing down, take a 7-0 early lead would be big. So, but on the flip side, St. Andrews thinking the same thing, cover this kick and try to get the ball back for their offense and see what they can do with it.
You said this just a few minutes ago, and I think it is definitely something to take into account here. Both of these teams coming in at 1-6, both of these teams coming in at 1-3, in the conference. Mm-hmm. Both of these teams, their one victory came this year against Union. Mm-hmm. And now, looking at those scores, St. Andrews back 2 weeks ago, back on October the 8th, won against Union 27-26. Well, the week before that, KCU was at Union, won that one 42-0. So a little bit of a different margin. But these are very, very similar teams as far as getting established. They're both trying to get their programs established. St. Andrews with a first-year head coach. Coach Russell's been here a couple of years, but he's getting himself established here. And I think the similarity between these two teams, at least from that standpoint, is something to focus on.
Yeah.
As we go to the Lord in prayer. And we're going to step out, take another one-minute break while we say the prayer here in the stadium. Back after this.
Uncle Rick, what are you doing?
I'm trying to stay cooler in my man cave.
Well, this is a beer cave, and you can't stay in this cooler forever.
But Clark's Pub and Shop can get you through the dog days of summer.
Whether it's fountain drinks at the lowest price or you're filling up the cooler for the family and friends, Clark's has the widest selection, the best prices, and the most helpful staff you'll find anywhere.
Beat the heat at Clark's Pub and Shop.
Return, refresh, refuel.
Are you having trouble keeping your parking lot lit? Is customer safety one of your top priorities? If so, call River City's Builders at 473-4112 for all your lighting needs. We have bucket truck and boom crane truck services. We have extensive experience in exterior lighting and parking lot lighting maintenance. No need to ever be in the dark again. Remember, call River City's Builders at 473-4112 for all your lighting needs. We will light your path to success.
Location, Stelz Pharmacy's newest location is at 437 James Hanna Drive in South Shore, but has retained the name you know and love, McDonald Pharmacy, with the same great service you'll find in the Greenup location, with free delivery service and their convenient drive-thru. Get your vaccinations and allergy shots, and of course, great prescription service. At Stelz Pharmacy in Greenup and McDonald Pharmacy, James Hanna Drive, South Shore.
Stelz Pharmacy.
When you have business away from home or a planned event far from your comfort zone, you're probably going to need a little help. Let A&A Porta Potties assist you with all your portable toilet needs. Whether on a construction site, planning for an outdoor wedding, or any other outdoor event, A&A Porta Potties are here to assist you. A&A Porta Potties also rents out storage containers, office containers, cooling fans, tables, and chairs. A&A Porta Potties, there is no event too big or too small for us to accommodate you.
And we're back here in Grayson. Coach, always a good opportunity to have the opportunity to stand up for that.
Absolutely.
And both teams making their way out here. And, Coach, it's time for some football.
Yeah, high noon here in Grayson, right?
Yes, sir.
Here we go,
yes, sir.
Big shootout. Two teams looking to get on the right track. Knight's going to put back Devontae Williams back deep. We'll see where they get him. He's returned 16 kickoffs so far for the Knights this year. He's got a 72-yarder, so we'll see whether St. Andrews is brave enough to kick it to him. We'd like to see Devontae get his hands on the ball early and get some good field position.
And Richmond Sims back deep, too. He's no slouch either.
Absolutely not.
Kicker for St. Andrews. Puts it in the air. It's going to fall right inside the 20-yard line. It's fielded by Richmond Sims. He's going to try to get it over to the KCU sideline. He's got some room to run and a decent return here to open things up. He pushed out of bounds right about the 37-yard line, and that's where KCU will take over on offense.
I think this is exactly what Coach Russell wanted, to get the offense out on the field first and see if they could take it down and get a score and kind of establish themselves here in this game.
That's right. As Maxwell Ward, you mentioned his stats there, improving every week. He wasn't the starter at the beginning of the year, and some injuries and all that, and he's came on really strong here, Coach.
Yeah, absolutely. He's played much better down the stretch, and look for him to have another big game today.
He's going to hand it off on first down to Josh Traylor, who gets off tackle left side and picks up about 3 yards on first down.
Yeah, a nice little counter run there to start the game. Trying to fill out that St. Andrews front a little bit, see if they can get something established along the line of scrimmage.
The pickup there was a long three, I'll say 4 yards, and we'll slant that one the KCU way for sure. So we'll say second down and 6 yards to go here. And that no-huddle offense, everybody getting their play call from the sideline. And here we go, a bunch of three receivers on the right. Ward takes a snap. He's going to throw a screen pass over to Devontae Williams, who's got some room to run. He's going to break it back across the field. Still not down, across midfield, and brought down at about the 41-yard line of St. Andrews. So a huge pickup on second down, Coach.
Yeah, little wide receiver screen out there. And then Devontae just kind of making some guys miss, brings it back across the middle of the field. Tough to bring down. A very shifty run.
Yes.
And picks up the first down. You know, very safe pass to get Max started here for his first throw. Get it out there in the flat and let your athletes do their thing.
Absolutely. Two receivers to the big side of the field. Ward takes a snap and another handoff here to Josh Traylor, trying to find some room to run, not able to find much. He gets it back to the line of scrimmage, and that's about it. Coach, you mentioned there Devontae. You called him shifty. And I don't know if you know this or not. That's a KCU athletic director, David Manning term. He's big on that word. He's shifty.
Yep.
A shout-out to that guy for sure.
Yep.
Second down, 10 yards to go now for the Knights. And, again, that no huddle. All the players wearing wristbands. They get their call from the sideline, check their wristband, and they're ready to go. Two-by-two set. Ball's closer to the middle field, shaded toward the right just a bit. The slot receiver goes in motion from right to left. Ward fakes a handoff, and he's hit from behind, and he loses the football, and it's picked up by St. Andrews. Big number 99, that's DeJuan Joyner.
Yeah, just cut the defensive end there from St. Andrews, just kind of beat our right tackle there. Kind of Max never saw him coming, got hit in the back, and so St. Andrews forces a fumble on the first drive, and they're going to get some decent field position here. And so this is when you need your defense to be ready to play in a sudden change situation, things that you practice all the time. And we'll see if the Knights can get them stopped here in this first series.
And I do want to say, I said DeJuan Joyner because if you look on my roster, it says DAWON Joyner.
Mm-hmm.
Dawson Joyner.
So Dawson.
I want to make sure I correct that.
Okay.
Big play there from him.
Yep.
Now here we go on first down. It's going to be a fake handoff. The quarterback's going to keep it himself. And he's gobbled up in the backfield, Coach. That is Andrew Fowler, the senior quarterback for St. Andrews. They faked the handoff, thought he had some room to run, but good job defensively there, collapsing down.
Yeah, a whole host of Knights there in on that play at D-line, not going for the fake, and they were ready to go. St. Andrews also a no-huddle, kind of up-tempo team, and they're right back on the ball.
Trips to the left, ball's on the right hash, running back to the right of Fowler. He's going to take a low snap, drop back, looks downfield under some pressure. He's going to keep it himself, gets it across the line of scrimmage, and a pretty decent pickup on second down. A gain of about 8 yards.
Yeah, Cameron Dunkel really pressing the pocket there from his D-line position. Forces Fowler out of the pocket. But he does a nice job of scrambling out to the right and finds a little bit of yardage and sets him up for a very makeable third down. St. Andrews in pretty good position here.
Yes, sir. Dennis Leggett, the running back, offset to the right of Fowler. Fowler takes a snap. It's going to be a handoff to Leggett, who gets it across the line of scrimmage. Picks up maybe a yard, but not enough for a first down. It's going to be fourth down and about 1 yard from the KCU 45-yard line.
Yeah, he's not going to make it there. Really good job holding that line of scrimmage. So it looks like a first big decision here for St. Andrews, and they're pretty quick to make it. They're going to try to go for it here on fourth down, looks like.
It doesn't seem like there was any hesitation, did it, Coach?
No, they were. I think they were planning on going for that the whole way. You know, they're St. Andrews so far this year. They've gone for it 26 times. They've been successful 12 times on fourth down. They got a late substitution here.
Yeah.
Play clock down to 5.
And here we go. He's going to be an offset fullback, a bunch set. One receiver to the right, ball's on the right hash, and a handoff up the middle to Leggett. And he charges ahead for a pickup of about 2 yards maybe, enough for the first down.
Yeah. The late substitution there for the Knights was trying to get in was Justin Fortner. He was the fullback, and he was also the lead blocker on that play and kind of cleared the way for that first down.
He did his job well.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, first and 10 for St. Andrews, the Knights of St. Andrews from down in North Carolina, Coach.
Yeah, Laurinburg, North Carolina, great area of the country. Going to be a free play here. The Knights jump off sides, and Fowler will take a shot down the left boundary.
It's picked off, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah, it's going to be picked off, but I think a free play there as one of the Knights was in the neutral zone at the snap. And so
that's why you do that. That's why, as a quarterback, Fowler knew, I'm going to take a shot, because even if it is picked off, it doesn't count anyway.
That's right. That's exactly right. Fowler, he's a senior, you know, about a 6 foot, 210-pound senior, and so he's played a lot of football, and he knew that he had a free play there, and so that'll set him up with a 1st and 5, you know. And that's the tough spot about a turnover around midfield
that
it puts St. Andrews in 4-down territory pretty quickly, and so you know, they were able to convert that 4th down. Now they're in a 1st and 5 situation, and probably in 4-down continue to be.
Fowler's going to take the snap. Another handoff up the middle to Leggett. Gets it across the line of scrimmage, and it's going to be for a gain, but not much of a gain. Maybe 2 yards, more than I thought, but 2nd down and about 3.
Yeah, inside linebacker there, Chandler Lamar, 6 foot, 210-pound do-everything linebacker for the Knights right there playing in the middle.
Yep.
And really made a nice read there and gobbled that up for a short game.
Lamar's one of those guys that we've talked about him on the Coach Russell show. He is really a leader on that defense.
Yeah, he's tuned in. He's always on his toes playing downhill.
This was a fake handoff. Fowler's going to keep it himself, trying to get over that KCU sideline. Able to do so, but he's knocked out of bounds after a pickup of about 4 yards, Coach, enough for another 1st down.
Yeah, a little inside zone read play there. And, again, Fowler, experienced guy, was able to read the defensive end and make a pull and kind of scramble out to his right a little bit. Forces the corner to make the play there. Shellman knocks him out of bounds, but picks up enough for a 1st down as it was first a short, if you remember.
Yes, sir. 1st and 10 now. Fowler takes a snap, hands off to Leggett, who's going to bounce outside to the left toward that St. Andrews sideline, picks up maybe 3 yards here. I forgot to mention, for those of you listening on the radio app, KCU in their home red uniforms, red jerseys, red pants, black numbers trimmed in silver, black helmets, and St. Andrews in all blue jerseys, blue pants, and a white helmet.
Yeah, kind of a color rush looking game out here. Red on red, blue on blue,
It's easy to distinguish who's who.
Yep.
Fowler's going to take the snap on 2nd down, throw it over toward his left to the flats, incomplete. The receiver there, that was Aronson Cook, a sophomore wide receiver, not able to haul that one in, just out of his reach.
KCU D-line continuing to pressure Fowler a little bit, not much time back there. He's got some guys in his face. That time it was C.J. Deals, able to kind of push the pocket and made him make an inaccurate throw. Wasn't a sack, not going to show up on the stats really, but kind of forced the inaccurate throw there.
Ball's on the left hash this time. Fowler's going to take it and sprint out to his right, throws it downfield toward the end zone. Good pass coverage there from KCU, and that one goes incomplete. And we do have a flag. I wonder, was there contact down there?
No, I think we've got guys downfield, ineligible guys downfield. So sprint out pass, not a bad idea by St. Andrews. They're getting pressure in the pocket, so they decide to sprint him out. It's a good idea, but I think a couple of the linemen from St. Andrews got a little anxious. And that's going to be the call. They're downfield, but incomplete pass. It's going to bring up 4th down. Knights will decline that. And we'll have our next 4th down play here from St. Andrews.
Yeah, 4th down and 7 this time instead of 4th and 1. It was 4th and 1, yeah.
Yeah.
So
a little different situation here, yeah.
I don't see any change of personnel it looks like they're going to go for it.
Yeah, it's base personnel. Yeah, they're going to go for it. You know, 13 out of 27 now, so we'll see where they convert here. A little different than a fourth and one.
Yes, sir, on the left hash. Fowler takes it, drops back, looks into the flats, and Coach, he had a receiver, but he got tripped up there. There was coverage, but he found a hole in the coverage and got the ball out there just out of his reach.
Yeah.
He tripped.
Fowler had a little time there and was able to set up and made a really good throw, a really strong throw. Monte Williams was over there, and I couldn't tell whether he got tripped up or just kind of fell coming out of his break, slipped and fell. But it's a good thing he did, because he would have had the first down. The ball appeared to be on target. But the Knights hold, nevertheless, and they get the ball back, and the turnover doesn't hurt them. So see if we can march it down the field. We had some things going there.
Yeah.
I think the offense looked good.
That's right.
Just got to continue hold on to the ball here and convert this time.
It's going to be first down and 10 yards to go for the Knights from their own 29-yard line as Maxwell Ward takes the snap. He's going to hand it off right side to Gerald Daniels, who I think he's going to go down as a loss of about one. I didn't know if he got it back to the line of scrimmage or not. I don't think he did.
Yeah, a little counterplay. A lot of people call it joker, where you're going to pull the guard and the tackle, counter or joker. Play back into the boundary there, not much room. Stout look over there from the St. Andrews defense. Not anywhere to go over there.
Trips to the left, balls over. It's on the right hash. I think we're going to try a hard count. Nothing going there. So everybody looks back over to get their play call. And here we go on second down and 11 yards to go on their own 28-yard line. We got one receiver in motion from right to left. A sprint out pass for Maxwell Ward. He's got a receiver. Ball thrown a little bit short. He had to reach out to catch it. And he's down where he caught it. So it's a gain of about 6 yards, makes it third and five, third and much more manageable.
Yeah, good job by Tay Anderson there, getting his hands underneath that ball on the a little bit of a short throw there, a little bit underthrown. He did a good job coming back to it. For those, again, watching on the app, just kind of set the defense for St. Andrews. They're a 3-4 team. They kind of get spread out just a little bit, but they're playing three down linemen. And right now Max has had good protection, except for it breaks down here just a little bit, just as I say that.
Yeah.
And number 54 there, Devin Turner, able to come up with the sack and going to force the Knights to punt the ball away.
That's right. On that play, as he took the snap, he was looking downfield, didn't have what he wanted. You could see him kind of directing traffic. He's one of those guys that can do that, but the pressure was too much. He couldn't get anything going.
Yeah, they just rushed three right there, you know, and he had a good protection so far, so I kind of spoke too soon. But when you drop eight, there's not a lot of – sometimes it gets real cloudy and there's nowhere to throw the ball, kind of forcing him to take the sack.
A good punt here from Paul Rodriguez is going to go out of bounds. It's actually fielded right before it goes out of bounds by KCU right at the St. Andrews 30-yard line. So that's where they'll take over. About a 42-yard punt, I think, Coach.
Yep.
Something like that.
Yeah, so a little back and forth here. Both teams trying to settle in a little bit. St. Andrews bring their offense back out on the field. They had a little bit of success there in that first drive. Got stalled out down there, so they're right back up on the ball. They're ready to go. They come off the sidelines ready to go.
Yes, sir. 7:03 to go in the first quarter. Still scoreless here between KCU and St. Andrews, the Knights and the Knights.
Yep, 10 personnel for St. Andrews, 4 receivers.
A 2-by-2 set, 1 receiver goes in motion. He's going to take the handoff on Jet, and he's gobbled up in the backfield, Coach.
Yeah, Justin Lewis coming off the slot, out there covering the slot. They run the Jet into him. He does a great job of setting the edge, takes on the blocker, defeats the block, makes a nice tackle. That's a really nice play from the freshman there. 5'11", 215, setting the edge on the defense, seeing the Jet sweep coming at him, and makes a really nice play.
So second down after the loss of one here. Second down, 11 yards to go for St. Andrews.
And they jump out of that 10 personnel real quick and get the fullback back in the game.
That's right. A fake handoff, a play action pass. Fowler sprints out to his left. He's got some room to run, and he's going to be forced out of bounds after a pickup of about 6 yards, making it third and five.
Yeah, Ellis Reed coming out of coverage right there. He had dropped back, has to come up and force Fowler out right before the first down marker. So it's going to set up, what, third and four there.
Third and four, yeah.
Fowler doing a nice job and not making the big mistake. Nobody open, pulls it down, makes a little something out of it, gives them a chance here on third down.
That's right.
And they'll stay with the fullback in the game. No tight end, 20 personnel.
Fowler going through his cadence, two wide receivers out to his right. He's going to drop back under some pressure again. He's forced to tuck it and run, and he runs straight ahead, open field, and more than enough here, Coach, for a first down.
Yeah, again, a little bit of pressure off the edge, and he's quick. Fowler's quick to pull it down and take off with it, certainly not afraid to run with it.
No. That's one thing we noticed early on. He's not afraid to do it, and he does it well.
Yeah, he is their second leading rusher on the team. And he's pulled the ball down. He's got 50 carries, probably going on 55 carries now, as he's already carried it four or five times here in the first quarter.
Clock's still rolling down to about 5.5 to go in the first quarter, and still scoreless here. St. Andrews with the football. Wide receiver goes in motion from right to left, as Fowler throws it downfield into the flats. And yeah, he's got some room to run down that sideline. That's Calvin Brown, who picks up more than enough for the first, crosses midfield, and he's forced out of bounds inside the 30-yard line of KCU.
Yeah, nice little bench route over there, a little down and out. Gets himself open, and Brown hauls it in, then makes a nice run down the boundary, breaks a couple tackles, and looks like we got a KCU night down on the far side. Fowler did, again, nice job avoiding the pressure. KCU has continually put a little pressure on Fowler, but he's done a really nice job of avoiding the pressure, sliding in the pocket. They've moved the pocket from time to time, and he was a little inaccurate early, but a couple of nice throws here, and they've picked up some chunk yards and moved the ball down inside the 30 here pretty quickly.
That's James Carradine, the knight that was down. He's back up and making his way off the field, and Coach, yep. I misspoke there. That was Caleb Madden who caught that pass. So
gotcha.
Make sure we give credit where credit's due.
Always, absolutely.
Now, I'm human and I make mistakes, but I always want to correct
surely
them
not.
If I can. Yeah.
Surely
yeah.
not. Surely not.
First and 10 for St. Andrews, and they're driving. They're on the KCU 28-yard line. And here we go. It looks like Fowler's going to be out of the pistol here. No, he's out of the gun. Running back offset to his left, takes the snap, looks to his left, finds a receiver. That's Aronson Cook over in the flats. He's going to march ahead for a pickup of maybe 6 yards on first down.
Yeah, just real quick throw, take advantage of the soft coverage and get it out there to Aronson into the boundary. He's a sophomore, not a small fella, 207 pounds, got his shoulders square and picked up a few yards after the catch.
You know, Fowler didn't complete a pass on that first drive. He's 2 for 2 here on this drive for 34 yards.
Yep.
2 by 2 set. No, we got two receivers out to the right, one to the left, and a tight end over there. And hard count. Now Fowler's going to take the snap looking downfield. Fakes a throw, and he throws it over there, but out of reach of his receiver, Coach, but I see a flag over that direction.
Yeah, generally in the area of holding.
Uh-huh, or blocking the back maybe, but I'm more of a hold kind of guy here. I don't know. We'll see. Yeah. It is a hold on St. Andrews. Of course, we usually don't get the number. I didn't see who it was, but that'll be a 10-yarder.
Yeah.
Holding against St. Andrews.
Would be nice if the official had the speaker and
he
could give us a number. It's tough to tell down in there sometimes. We don't get a video replay, so it's difficult trying to watch what everything goes on down there inside. Can be very difficult to see from where we're at. But nevertheless, not surprising because KCU has pressured Fowler.
Yeah.
He's done a good job of not of getting away from that pressure, making something out of it, but that'll be something to watch as the game goes by.
That's right. Was 2nd and 5. Now it's 2nd and 15 for St. Andrews. Ball's on the left hash. 2 by 2 set. Running back offset to the right of Fowler. He's going to take the snap immediately under pressure. And, Coach, that's going to go down as a quarterback sack.
Yep. So they finally brought a little pressure.
Yep.
And trying to say it looks like Ellis may have been in on that sack. I think 97 is probably going to get credit for that. That's Trent Hill, and Ellis was in a little bit late, and he looks a little bit shaken up, and Ellis is not a guy that we want to lose off that defense. He's very versatile in coverage. He can blitz, so that'll be something to keep an eye on as he's kind of holding his shoulder over there. But I think Trent Hill is going to get credit for that sack.
Okay. Trips to the right, and ball still on the left hash. Third down and a long way to go as Fowler's hit as he throws it downfield, and Coach, that's an interception, but it's out of bounds.
Yeah, and Trent Hill again with pressure on Fowler.
He
delivered a very strong hit, a very clean hit right in the midsection just as Fowler let the ball go, drove him down to the turf, and Fowler's going to feel that. And that's what created that kind of throw that was just kind of up in the air for grabs.
Yeah.
And lucky that it kind of floated out of bounds there, or might have been an interception.
Now, we've seen St. Andrews go for it twice now on fourth down. Yep. But it was fourth and one time, and fourth and I think five maybe the second time.
Yep.
Here we got fourth and 17, but I still see the offense on the field.
Yeah, so kind of in that area, too far to kick a field goal. You know, you don't get a lot out of punting the ball right here. So they're going to try to get something down the field.
Fowler under pressure. He sprints out to his right, throws it downfield into the end zone. And, Coach, incomplete. Overthrows his receiver. Good coverage there. And that's a turnover on downs.
Yeah, coverage was there. Looked good. It was J.R. Smith on the coverage there, and he was all over his guy, and they just kind of lobbed the ball up there. It was Arneson Cook. They was trying to be the intended receiver, but really not open. Not much Fowler could do, but just kind of throw it up there and maybe give him a chance to catch it, but really overthrown. And so the KCU defense holds, and you know, they trot the offense back out there and see if they can get it going.
Yep, this is the third time we've seen them. We're still scoreless here, 3:20 to go in the first quarter as Maxwell Ward takes a snap, throws it over to a screen pass, and a hit as he catches the ball. That's Austin Mullins. So it is a catch, but it's no gain.
Yeah, kind of a slow throw out there, wide receiver screen outside the numbers. Took a little while for that to develop. And looked like number six, Jalen Irvin, able to make a tackle there.
Be second down and 10 yards to go here for KCU offensively. Ball this time's on the left hash, and they're on their own 35-yard line, we'll say. Ward takes a snap. He's going to hand it off to Josh Traylor, who tries to get that edge, not able to do so. Gets it, I think, back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all.
Yeah, give some credit to Elijah Stokes there, number 35 for the St. Andrews Knights. Only a freshman, 205, did a nice job of setting the edge and forcing that ball back to the teeth of that defense.
Third down and 10 yards to go now for KCU. We see some substitutions up front. I think Sione Mawala came off, and it looks like Waylu Henry, a junior D lineman, came on. He's listed as a D lineman, but he just went in on the offensive line there.
Yeah, sometimes in small college football, guys got to be versatile.
Absolutely.
You want to get on the field, learn a couple positions.
Ward under pressure. He's hit as he throws it downfield, and I think he was just getting rid of that one, Coach.
Yeah, not really anywhere to go with that ball. They continue to put a little pressure on Max there. That was Devin Turner able to kind of chase him down. And he threw the ball back across the field. And, you know, that's not something when you get out there. It'd be nice just to maybe see him. Wasn't really many red shirts over that way. Like, see, maybe just throw out of the pocket, just throw that ball away and not, you know, not put it in risk of one of those bad interceptions that Jake was talking about before. So the St. Andrews defense holds again, right? Two times in a row now.
That's right.
A
three and out. We see a Paul Rodriguez punt landed about the 35-yard line. It's going to go out of bounds. It's going to take a KCU bounce and go out of bounds somewhere. I guess they're going to say it went out of bounds about the 35. Looks like it might be where they're putting the football.
St. Andrews huddled up on the boundary over there, and they're going to come right off that boundary ready to go. Knights defense getting ready. Again, they've been able to put pressure on Fowler pretty consistently.
Yeah.
Certainly making it uncomfortable. See what kind of personnel they come with. They got their big fullback in there. They stay with 20 personnel. What I mean by that is they have no tight ends. That's two running backs. They got a fullback and a tailback in the game. They got three wide receivers with no tight end. That's how we get 20 personnel.
I think big fullback might be an understatement, Coach. That's Solomon Mitchell, a senior fullback. We don't have his height, but he's listed 290 pounds.
Yep.
Handoff is on first down is going to go to Devontae Allen, who gets the edge. He's got a little bit of room to run there. It's the first time we've seen him carry the football, and he's got some speed.
Yeah, he does. He's able to kind of break it out. He only has three carries. Only has 34 carries on the year for 130 yards. Looked like he had a second gear there.
Picked up 6 yards there on first down. Makes it second down and 4 yards to go.
Yep.
Two receivers over to the short side of the field. That's the left side. Ball is on the left hash as Andrew Fowler out of the gun takes the snap. And I saw some movement there on both sides of the football. I anticipate a false start here.
Yeah, I believe you're right. Yeah, I think the left side looked like the left guard and tackle from St. Andrews got a little jump on the play there. And
yeah.
So that's going to push them back five after a pretty good gain there. On first down, that's going to send them back and make it second and nine.
So a good break there for the KCU defense, makes it second and nine. And the clock's running. We're under a minute to go here in the first quarter, still scoreless between KCU and St. Andrews.
Yep. They'll stay with 20 personnel with Big Solomon in there as the H-back, kind of a fullback set close to the line of scrimmage.
A handoff on second and nine. And bouncing off a would-be tackler is Devontae Allen, who's going to bring it ahead for a pickup of about 11 yards, more than enough for a first down.
Yeah, and Big Solomon there leading the way on the counter play.
Uh-huh.
Gets a nice block and kind of springs Devontae Allen there for a nice gain.
So first and 10 for St. Andrews here. Ball is on the St. Andrews 46-yard line, so almost to midfield, and they have time for one more play. Clock's down to 13 and still running, and I think they're going to try for one more play here in this first quarter. Down to 7 seconds as Fowler takes a snap. Another handoff. It's going to go to Allen, who bounces off another would-be tackler, and he's running down the sideline, crossing the 30-yard line of KCU, and he's going to be knocked out of bounds around the 25. So a big-time pickup here. And that's going to do it for quarter number one, Coach. So we're still scoreless. St. Andrews on the move. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
Uncle Rick, what are you doing?
I'm trying to stay cooler in my man cave.
Well, this is a beer cave, and you can't stay in this cooler forever.
But Clark's Pub and Shop can get you through the dog days of summer.
Whether it's fountain drinks at the lowest price or you're filling up the cooler for the family and friends, Clark's has the widest selection, the best prices, and the most helpful staff you'll find anywhere.
Beat the heat at Clark's Pub and Shop.
Return, refresh, refuel.
When you want real, authentic Mexican menu items, you want Tres Hermanos Nunez. Accept no substitutes. None compares. Fajitas, tacos, burritos, quesadillas, chimichangas, even vegetarian choices. A kid's menu, desserts, and salads, a tasty, budget-pleasing selection for you and your family, unlike any others, should be your first and only choice for authentic Mexican all throughout the tri-state. Ashland, Greenham, Grayson, Paintsville, Canova, South Point, Olive Hill, and Cannonsburg. Tres Hermanos Nunez, the best around.
And we're back here in Grayson. Chauncey Griffith, Brent Terry, glad to have you along. And still scoreless, Coach. I don't know that I expected this. I expect a little bit more points on the board here after a quarter.
Yeah, a little bit surprised that the first drive of the game, KCU had a little something going, and then had the quarterback sack, the strip sack that caused the fumble. And, you know, the defense has played pretty well so far. St. Andrews has had the ball down inside the 33 times, I believe, and still don't have any points. This might be their third or fourth trip inside the 30-yard line.
Yeah.
And so we'll see what they do. And, we were just talking there in the break that Leggett and Allen are a really nice 1-2 punch
for this
offense. Allen has had some nice carries here, and he'll get it again.
He's hit around the line of scrimmage, maybe for a bit of a loss here on second down. He's got three carries so far before this one for 55 yards. But that one's going to go down as his first loss. So make that four carries now for 54 yards unofficially.
Yeah, Zach Thomas coming off the edge there and able to make the play in the backfield. So we still no personnel change for they stay remain with the two backs and three wide receivers in the game.
Fullback offset to the right. A handoff. A fake handoff this time. Fowler's going to keep it himself and march ahead. He shakes off a couple would-be tacklers and picks up a gain of about 5 yards, maybe 4 or 5 yards here, Coach. He's one of those quarterbacks, though. He showed us right there. He lowered his shoulder and got what he could up the middle.
Yeah, nice hard run by Fowler there, fighting for some extra yards, running like a tailback really up in there, showing no signs of trying to find trying to get down or anything like that. He's trying to fight for every yard he could get.
I respect it. And we do see a little change in personnel here, Coach, but it looks like Big Solomon, the fullback, still on the field. I think they just switched out receivers.
Yeah, just took out a couple receivers, put a couple new guys in.
Dylan Arroyo now out wide here for St. Andrews. As Fowler takes the snap. He's going to look downfield. He looks to throw, and a hard throw there off the hands of Aronson Cook. He goes incomplete, fourth down.
Yeah, and they had a receiver open deep there, 86. Arroyo was open, and Fowler missed him. So we'll see if that's something they come back to later in the game. But he definitely had a chance there. So we'll see if that finally, instead of going for it on fourth down, they elect to kick a field goal here on fourth down.
Be a 32-yarder. Ball's on the 22-yard line. And Coach, that matchup of, well, I'll say it in a second. The kick's in the air. I think somebody might have got a hand on that, Coach. It's way low, and it's no good. Still scoreless.
Yeah, that kind of came out funny. It looked like maybe somebody did get a hand on it there in the middle, and that ball kind of spiraled through the end zone, really never had any chance of getting close.
And you were talking there, the open receiver downfield, Arroyo, instead Fowler elected to throw it to Aronson Cook. We've seen him trying to get the ball in the hands of Ronson Cook several times here today. He's got one catch so far for 6 yards, but I feel like those two might mesh a little bit. That might be a matchup that the quarterback feels comfortable with. Nonetheless, Maxwell Ward takes a snap. He's going to hand it off on first down, and bouncing it back to the other side is Gerald Hicks, but he's gobbled up in the backfield for a minimal loss. Nothing there, Coach. He just tried to get somewhere and find some green grass. Not able to do so, though.
Yep.
I said Gerald Hicks. That's Gerald Daniels.
Yep. Monte Williams there coming from his linebacker position, his inside linebacker position there for St. Andrews to make that play.
Ward takes a snap with three receivers to his right. He finds one of them on a slant route. That's Devontae Williams, who's got room to run. Crosses the 50, bending it back over toward the sideline, and he's off to the races. 10-5, touchdown, KCU, Coach. And that's just what the doctor ordered.
Absolutely. Take a nice little control pass there, hit the short pass over the middle, and let the receiver do the rest.
He's got two catches now, Coach, for 97 yards. One of them was a 79-yard touchdown, and KCU puts points on the board first here. We're 12:39 to go in the ball game. It's 6-0, and I see Paul Rodriguez out there, so they're going to try to tack one more on.
Yeah. So there's what you might have been expecting. You talked about you're a little bit surprised we had a scoreless first quarter.
Yeah.
Just took a little bit of time, but finally a quick strike from the Kentucky Christian offense.
The kick's up. And it's good. So Paul Rodriguez tacks on one more. That makes it 7-0 KCU with 12:39 to go before halftime. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
You know, financial security begins at home with home ownership. If you've been putting off looking for a home because you think you can't afford it, you owe it to yourself to check out Members Choice Credit Union. Members Choice Credit Union has programs for first-time homebuyers and more to help put you in the home of your dreams. Call, click, or stop by Members Choice Credit Union today.
Members Choice Credit Union, NMLS 411-945, Equal Housing Lender. Call for additional information. Other restrictions may apply.
When you want real, authentic Mexican menu items, you want Tres Hermanos Nunez. Accept no substitutes. None compares. Fajitas, tacos, burritos, quesadillas, chimichangas, even vegetarian choices. A kid's menu, desserts, and salads. A tasty, budget-pleasing selection for you and your family, unlike any others. Should be your first and only choice for authentic Mexican all throughout the tri-state. Ashland, Greenham, Grayson, Paintsville, Canova, South Point, Olive Hill, and Cannonsburg. Tres Hermanos Nunez, the best around.
And we're back here in Grayson. Chauncey Griffith, Brent Terry, glad to have you along. KCU with points on the board, Coach, 7-0 here with 12:39 to go before the half.
Yeah, and that'll add a spark. That'll add a little momentum to this KCU Knights team. You know, that when you're playing a team you think that you're going to beat, and it's kind of back and forth, and you start to press a little bit, then you finally hit that big play right there and kind of get that first score up on the board, light that gets everybody going a little bit.
A good kick from Paul Rodriguez, fielded about the 4-yard line. Returner there was Eldrick Williams, and he's going to bring it out. A decent return gets it up to the 25-yard line, and that's where St. Andrews, the Knights of St. Andrews, will take over. The Knights versus the Knights.
Yeah. So St. Andrews has had some success running the ball in their last drive there. They kind of got down the red, you know, close to the red zone and weren't able to convert, end up trying a field goal that didn't look very good. So we'll see whether they come out and whether they're still going to be try to establish a run. Looks like they're going to put Leggett back in. You know, Leggett and Allen have been a nice little 1-2 punch.
Sure.
They've had a hard time protecting Fowler. KCU with three down right now, and their defensive front will send. They've brought pressure, and they do again here.
Fowler throws it way downfield. They're going to take a shot, and Coach, that one almost picked off the ball, just a little bit underthrown, and that is J.R. Smith, the junior defensive back. Almost, that one was off his hands instead of the receiver. So great pass coverage there.
Yeah, the receiver there, Ronson Cook, a little bit of a height advantage there. We don't have height on these guys, but he looks to be at least 6'3", 6'4", and so he had a little bit of a height advantage. So a very nice play there on the coverage to kind of make up for the height difference. JR able to kind of get that ball out of there.
I kind of expected him to try to take a shot on first down. But we see a running play here on second down, and marching it ahead is Leggett. Gets off tackle to the right-hand side and gains about 9, maybe 10 yards. It's close to a first. It's going to depend on the spot, and they're moving the chain. So a 10-yard gain there on second down.
Yeah, Leggett, senior running back. He's their leading rusher this year, and he a very nice run there on the edge, a little outside zone play, and quick out to the edge. He's got good size, good quickness. He's not quite as fast as the other back, Allen, but he's a little heavier and runs through a few more tackles.
Absolutely. We see three backs in the backfield as Fowler takes the snap, throws it to his right. That's a Ronson Cook over there on a screen route who marches ahead for another first down.
Yeah, we've seen that a couple times. They like to throw. If you give them a little room into the boundary there, Fowler just takes it, whips it out there, just kind of a one-step route, and lets his receiver kind of do the work after that. Cook, good size, sophomore, 207, gets his shoulder square, and he's hard to bring down, as JR's not the biggest DB out there, so he's able to get some yards. Looks like kind of at the end of the play there, we had a flag that I didn't necessarily see, but the initial indication is a personal foul against the Knights. I don't know if it was a late hit or somebody said something, but either way, it's going to be another 15 for St. Andrews. And again, here they march inside the 40.
So that's not a good thing, obviously, for KCU. The ball's going to cross midfield. And first and 10 from the KCU 40 for St. Andrews. Now 2-by-2 set as Fowler's screen. Immediately under pressure, but a design screen and Devontae Allen is going to bring it ahead there, Coach. I got a little bit tongue-tied. That was a design pressure, and he dropped back, and just dumped the ball over to Allen. And a big pickup here on first down.
Yeah. Only Allen's fourth catch on the year, but a very nice, well-designed screen play there. Fowler, being the senior, draws the defense in, kept drawing back, let them get the pressure there, and they're able to dump it over their heads, and Allen takes a short pass and turns into a long gain.
That's right. As Fowler takes a snap here on first down, he's going to hand it off, and marching it ahead is Devontae Allen for a pickup of around 4 or 5 yards there. And, Coach, the St. Andrews offense clicking here.
Yeah, they're finally able to get the ball. You know, they've had the ball inside the 30 a couple times, but this might be their first run inside the 20 to get in the red zone. So we'll see. They have not been great in the red zone this year. They've been down there. I was checking the stats earlier. They've only been down in that red zone a few times this year and converting on about half their opportunities. So we'll see whether the Knights defense, KCU Knights defense, can hold them out.
Fowler sprints out to his right, and he's going to keep it himself for positive yards. He went out of bounds, Coach, right around the first down marker, and it's going to depend on where they say he – it's all the way over on the other side of the field, so I think he's going to be a yard or two short, a couple yards short maybe.
Yep. A little yard. Nice job of scrambling again away from pressure. We've said that a couple of times already today. Fowler able to escape the pocket and make something positive.
He's been pretty effective on the ground and in the air as well. He didn't complete a pass his first three passes he threw, but after that, 72 yards. He's going to hand it off here on third down to Devontae Allen again, who's going to march it ahead for a gain right side. It's going to be close to a first down, Coach, but I think he's going to be short, about a yard short.
Probably just a hair short. And we'll see they run a little counter play there, and I see big Solomon Mitchell coming off the sideline there.
Okay.
They go with their heavy package. They'll put him a fullback. Again, he looks to be about 6 foot two or three and a good 290.
He's listed at 290, so and I believe it.
Yeah.
Big, big boy.
So they actually line him up at tight end this time. They have a second fullback in the game.
Handoff, though, is going to go to Allen. He's going to march straight ahead, and he's hit at the line.
Boy, it's going to be really close from this angle.
Real close, yes, sir.
Very difficult to tell. Not much movement, but a quick signal from the white hat. It's going to be a first down.
Okay. First down and goal now from around the 8 or 9 yard line. We'll say the 8 yard line. For St. Andrews.
Result of play, the first down be first and goal.
I'll be honest, from where I was sitting, I wasn't sure if he had enough. I'm not even sure. I wasn't even sure if it was for a gain. I thought he just got it back to the line, but they say he got about a yard. So.
Yep, heavy personnel in. They got Solomon Mitchell lined up at tight end. They have Fortner at the fullback position. They give it to Allen again.
He's hit hard in the backfield by several defenders. Coach, what a play there defensively.
Yeah, that was a red rush right there.
Yes, sir. I like that.
They were able to just kind of swarm Allen right there, and he really had nowhere to go. It looked like they gave up two or three gaps there and make a nice play for a tackle. Good time for a tackle for loss.
It's going to be second down and goal now from the 11-yard line. I didn't see a change in personnel here. We got two receivers to the right, one to the left. Ball's on the right hash. There was movement, so a free play here. And a touchdown in the back corner of the end zone for St. Andrews.
Yeah, we got a flag on the play, though. The lines judge over there on the far side threw a flag very early. Often that's an illegal formation.
I thought it might have been. I saw movement from the defense. Yeah. We'll wait and see here.
Yeah.
Yeah, touchdown.
Yeah, it's they're giving the signal that someone was lined up in the neutral zone there, and so that penalty is going to be declined. And so they pack them all in. They get a one-on-one on the outside, and they're able to take advantage with Marquise McCoy. Junior wide receiver able to go up and kind of box out the KCU defender and get the touchdown.
So the PAT is up and it's good as well. So that means we're tied up at 7 here, Coach, with 8:07 to go in the second quarter. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
In addition to the Greenup location, Stelz Pharmacy's newest location is at 437 James Hanna Drive in South Shore, but has retained the name you know and love, McDonald Pharmacy, with the same great service you'll find in the Greenup location, with free delivery service and their convenient drive-thru. Get your vaccinations and allergy shots, and of course, great prescription service. At Stelz Pharmacy in Greenup and McDonald Pharmacy, James Hanna Drive, South Shore.
Stelz Pharmacy.
When you have business away from home or a planned event far from your comfort zone, you're probably going to need a little help. Let A&A Porta Potties assist you with all your portable toilet needs, whether on a construction site, planning for an outdoor wedding or any other outdoor event, A&A Porta Potties are here to assist you. A&A Porta Potties also rents out storage containers, office containers, cooling fans, tables, and chairs. A&A Porta Potties, there is no event too big or too small for us to accommodate you.
Back here in Grayson, Coach, 7-7. St. Andrews with an answer, but the last time we saw that KCU offense, they were clicking on all cylinders.
Yeah, an impressive drive there. From St. Andrews, they were able to take advantage of several different personnel groupings. They did a good job of mixing those up. Finally, at the end, Fowler throws his fifth touchdown pass on the season.
Yep.
He gets the ball out there. Nice little fade route. If you're listening on the radio, just a little fade route in the corner of the end zone, and McCoy boxes him out and gets the touchdown. So they'll pooch kick it over there to the 40-yard line.
That's Calvin Brown there, Coach. He caught the ball, hit the ground, did what he was supposed to do because those defenders were coming hard.
Yeah, they decided they don't want to kick this thing deep to any of the KCU's returners. So they're going to give the Knights a ball around the 40-yard line, the KCU Knights a ball around the 40-yard line here. And so, as you said, they were able to – last time we saw them on offense, a nice little short pass, and they were able to take it the distance. So we'll see where they can repeat that.
First and 10, they have it at the 40-yard line. KCU balls on the left hash, and Maxwell Ward directed a little traffic there pre-snap. He's going to take the snap, drop back to pass, looking downfield, not finding his man, still directing a little traffic. Plenty of time, and he just dives ahead, Coach, for a minimal gain. The pressure was kind of closing down, but good job there by the O-line. He had a lot of time to throw.
Yeah, had plenty of time to throw there. Just couldn't find an open window. St. Andrews only rushing three, dropping eight into coverage. Really nobody open, and Max didn't really have anything to do with it, but finally they're tuck it down and not able to quite get back to the line of scrimmage, and somebody from St. Andrews is going to get credit with the sack.
That's right. So second down and 11 yards to go from the 39-yard line now. Ball's on the right hash this time. Three bunch receivers to the left, a fake handoff and a bootleg, and Ward's going to look downfield, and the ball just out of the reach. He threw it into some coverage there, but incomplete pass on second down.
Yeah, they go with a little bunch set to left. First time we've seen that. Little play action there, and they try to kind of run the we call a hide route, where they bring the inside receiver back behind the line of scrimmage and into the flat back on the right for the bootleg. But they did a nice job of covering that. He tried to force the ball down the field into some coverage, maybe a throw that like to maybe see kind of sail out of bounds there when they're covered like that.
Exactly. A snap it or a flag as the ball snapped. And Ward throws the ball downfield. I didn't see what the flag was, Coach, but I anticipate maybe some movement at the snap or somebody in the neutral zone again, something like that.
Yeah, I think Max knew he had a free play.
That's
there,
right.
And able to give it off there. And they're really picking on Jalen Irvin over here, the freshman corner from St. Andrews, and he's going to take himself out of the game there. He's covered two really long routes, and they'll bring in Tedrick Spicer here as he comes in and gives him a break over here at left corner.
Here we go, trips to the left again as Ward takes it. He's going to throw it. And it's caught. I'm trying to get a number there, Coach. Nonetheless, a gain of about 7 yards, more than enough for the first down, maybe 8 yards. And I'm still trying to see who that receiver is that caught that ball.
Yeah, I'm not sure either. Chance, real quick throw there.
That's Kayron Taylor. I'm sorry.
Okay,
yeah.
Good. First down. So Kayron makes a nice play, turns a short pass into a first down there. KCU checking out on the sidelines, trying to get some guys in and out of the game there.
Hundred and five passing yards now for Maxwell Ward on four attempts. He's going to send the fullback in motion, takes the snap, fakes a handoff, throws it downfield, and it was almost caught there, in and out of the hands of Calvin Brown. Goes incomplete. I thought he had the football, but he was hit when he was making the catch. And the ball hit the ground.
Yeah, Nicky Walters coming in from his safety spot, kind of jarring that ball loose. I think if he had not, Calvin would have came down with it.
Yeah.
So you know, credit Walters there with the play of the nice pass breakup.
Got a timeout on the field. The officials there right about where the ball would be spotted. I'm not sure, but we got players from both sides checking on what they're talking about.
Yeah, kind of having a little huddle there. Yeah. Maybe the head referee, the white hat, stepping in just to maybe calm things down just a little bit. Inside there, it's just a lot of things are said and done that it's hard to see from up here.
They don't call that the trenches for nothing.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's trench warfare going on in there. Sometimes you got to calm those guys down a little bit.
Ward takes a snap, drops back. The ball is deflected, but he finds a receiver, and off to the races is number 80, Taylen Rucker Daly. Gets it across the 20-yard line, Coach, all the way over on that St. Andrews sideline, and he's going to be knocked out of bounds inside the 20.
Yeah, when that ball got tipped, the DB or the linebacker there in coverage kind of went for the intercept, kind of went for the ball and lost his man, and Rucker hauled it in and made a nice run. He was going a little crossing route there, and just a short pass of 3 or 4 yards turns into a long gain, and the Knights are in business inside the 20.
Yes, sir, a 33-yard pickup there for Taylen Rucker Daly.
Great concentration by Taylen there to kind of keep his eyes on that ball as it was tipped.
Ward hands it off on first down now to Joshua Traylor, and he's hit out of bounds, and we've got flags flying everywhere.
Yeah, I think we're going to get a face mask there as he was pulled down. So that should be going to get a half a distance to the goal there from the face mask penalty.
From the spot of the foul, is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. From the spot of the foul, so he'll get the gain, and then a personal foul, face mask. It's going to move it inside the 10.
He picked up 3 yards there, so a big ball was on the 16. So that brings down to the 13. So I'm anticipating around the 6 or 7 yard line, maybe something like that.
Yep, that's it.
I don't know. I've got a big post in my line of vision, so I'm having to lean forward there. And I was writing, so I was just doing that math in my head.
Yep.
I'm not usually very good at math, but the ball's on the 7 yard line. And I think the quarterback kept himself there. Maxwell Ward's going to march it ahead inside the 5 yard line. Picks up 2 or 3, maybe 4 yards.
Williams going to carry about down at the 4 yard line.
Quarterback.
Yeah, Coach, we've got it. Thanks for pointing that out there. We do have a backup quarterback in the game. That's Tyler Haas in there, and he's the one that marched that ahead.
Mm-hmm.
So Tyler Haas, the man behind the center, takes the snap. He's going to keep it himself again, and he looks left into the end zone. Touchdown,
yeah.
KCU.
Yeah, they put Tyler in there to kind of give him a little spark there, it looked like, and he was able to run the ball down there on the goal line, and you get an extra blocker when you're able to run the quarterback like that, and a nice little isolation play over there on the left, and Haas runs it in for the touchdown.
That's a good option to have.
Yeah, it is. Able to come in and put another running back in the game basically there able to get an extra lead blocker and even out the numbers and get the ball in the end zone.
So that put KCU back ahead 13-7, and Paul Rodriguez is on to try to make it 14. The kick's up, and it is good. So that means with 5:11 to go here before the half, your score, KCU 14, St. Andrews 7. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
Jennifer Epperly, loan officer at First National Bank in Canonsburg. I personally invite you and all local businesses to visit our beautiful new building in Canonsburg on U.S. Route 60 next to the Walmart entrance. We offer many services including personal, mortgage, and business loans. First National Bank is locally owned by the McGuire family of Ashland and has been in business since 1902. We aim to give you the personal attention and best customer service there is to offer. Come inside, talk with us, and let us make you a part of the First National Bank family. First National Bank, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC.
Kentucky Christian University is a private nonprofit university located in the beautiful foothills of eastern Kentucky. KCU offers both undergraduate and graduate programs, including the new Teacher Leader Master of Arts in Education degree. They also have an array of competitive sports. Kentucky Christian University is committed to focusing on Christ while helping students build character and prepare for their future careers. Visit kcu.edu to learn more or to schedule a visit on campus.
back in Grayson. Chauncey Griffith, Brent Terry, glad to have you along. KCU ahead right now 14-7 as Paul Rodriguez puts a kick in the air. It's going to land right inside the 5-yard line, and it's fielded here by an all.
Yeah, Allen.
That's him, yeah. A guy we've said his name quite a bit, and a good return from him. He gets it past the 25. I think he went out of bounds maybe 26 or 27, so a decent return there.
Yeah, he'll set them up in decent field position, gets it out past the 25-yard line. Devontae Allen can really go. He's a good-looking player,
yeah.
Good-looking running back. And like I said earlier, he and Leggett are a nice 1-2 punch in there. And Fowler able to do some things. So they got some weapons on offense. Casey Unite playing good on defense. We've seen after a scoreless first quarter, we've kind of seen things open up, and it's been back and forth. And
right.
I think the last three possessions for each team, if I'm not mistaken, have resulted in touchdowns. KCU scored first, and the Knights from
offside on KCU.
Oh, okay. So the Knights from St. Andrews were able to score, and then the KCU comes back with their second touchdown of the game. So looks like somebody from KCU was offsides on the kickoff. That was a discussion whether St. Andrews wanted them to re-kick or just take the 5 after the return, and it looks like they're going to make them re-kick this thing. So that'll push them back to the 30-yard line for the kickoff, and Rodriguez will have to boot it away again and give Allen another chance at it here, see if they kick it to Devontae again.
Paul Rodriguez does a great job. He consistently puts it inside the 10, around the 5-yard line every time he kicks off here. So with the penalty back to the 30, that should put it around the 20 or the 15-yard line.
Yeah, we'll see if he can. There's little to no wind blowing out today, so you expect him still to get this ball down inside, like I said, inside between the 10 and 15-yard line. You just want to be careful about giving Allen a chance to break it open here.
This time we're going to have a little pooch kick, Coach. It's going to land around the 30-yard line. This time it's going to be fielded by Cam Lackey, who's going to bring it to the middle of the field and get it almost midfield. He goes down around the 44-yard line of St. Andrews. So good field position. I think the penalty might have paid off a little bit for
St.
Andrews.
Yeah, so a good decision there for St. Andrews to go ahead and make them re-kick it. And they didn't want to put the ball in Allen's hands again. So they kick it short there. And they get about 24 yards or so of field position out of that exchange.
I would say the special teams coach told Paul, hey, I want you to kick it right at number 85. And he kicked it right at number 85. He didn't even move a step. It landed right in his chest.
Yep. So about 5 minutes on the clock here to see whether St. Andrews can get it tied up here before the half.
Fowler drops back on first down, finds a receiver who's hit as he throws, but he shakes off the would-be tackler. That's Dennis Leggett, that part of that 1-2 punch out of the backfield. He catches it in the flats, gets knocked out of bounds right across midfield. Pickup of maybe 7 yards is going to be second and 3.
Yeah, I thought Shelman there, the right corner from KCU, had a really good bead on him and saw the ball coming to the flat, and he was able to kind of – but he just didn't wrap him up. I thought he was going to have a really big hit there, but he kind of bounced off of him, and receiver able to get down the boundary for some more yards, and they take him out, and they'll put J.R. Smith back in at right corner.
Fowler takes a snap, another screen over to the left side to Aronson Cook, who's down the sideline, got room to run, crosses a 10-5 touchdown, St. Andrews.
Third time, we've seen that little quick, the soft coverage by KCU. They take it, and Fowler flicks it out there into the boundary real quick, and Cook able to kind of turn that play into a touchdown there. A 1-yard route, fourth time we've seen it. It's gone for positive yards each time. That time, a bunch of yards down the boundary there.
Yeah, 49-yard touchdown, Coach.
Yeah, 49 yards throw and catch there. A 1-yard throw and a 48-yard run.
The kick is up. I think somebody might have got a hand on it again, but it's a low kick, but it is good.
Yeah.
So that means that with 4:09 to go here, before the half, your score is back tied, this time at 14, KCU and St. Andrews. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
You know, financial security begins at home with home ownership. If you've been putting off looking for a home because you think you can't afford it, you owe it to yourself to check out Members' Choice Credit Union.
Members Choice Credit Union has programs for first-time homebuyers and more to help put you in the home of your dreams. Call, click, or stop by Members Choice Credit Union today.
Members Choice Credit Union, NMLS 411-945, Equal Housing Lender. Call for additional information. Other restrictions may apply.
When you want real, authentic Mexican menu items, you want Tres Hermanos Nunez. Accept no substitutes. None compares. Fajitas, tacos, burritos, quesadillas, chimichangas, even vegetarian choices. A kid's menu, desserts, and salads. A tasty, budget-pleasing selection for you and your family, unlike any others. Should be your first and only choice for authentic Mexican all throughout the tri-state. Ashland, Greenham, Grayson, Paintsville, Canova, South Point, Olive Hill, and Cannonsburg. Tres Hermanos Nunez, the best around.
Kick in the middle of the field. Almost a spell trouble there. It bounced around and bounced around. Finally able to get on that football was Calvin Brown, and he downed it right around the 35-yard line. So KCU with decent field position here. Plenty of time to make something happen offensively here before the half.
Yeah, still 4 minutes to go here. Plenty of time to get this thing down, see if they can get some more points on the board.
Yep.
They've had a couple of quick strikes. Maxwell Ward back in the game.
Here we go. Maxwell Ward takes the snap, drops back, looking downfield. He's got time to throw. He finds a receiver, but just not able to connect with him, Coach. On a cross route there in the middle of the field, VT Taylor downfield, and the ball just out of his reach.
Yeah, Ward had plenty of time. Credit that KCU offensive line for holding tight right there. Again, they're dropping eight, but kind of a single receiver route right there.
Yep.
They put Vincent down the post and just kind of led him just a little bit too much as he had a step on the safety.
Second down and 10 yards to go now for KCU. Clock at 4 minutes, stopped at 4 minutes. And the ball's on the 35-yard line of the Knights as Ward takes a snap. It's going to be a handoff this time. Devontae Williams gets over to the sideline of St. Andrews, and he's hit hard as he goes out of bounds after about a 7-yard pickup.
Yeah, they run a little counterplay back into the boundary right there.
And, he
bounces it out, toward the boundary, able to get a few yards and set up a very makeable third and five.
No huddle offense. All the offensive players looking over to the sideline at Coach Russell. He's got a play. He's actually got a player over there signaling the plays in. And here we go. Running our receiver goes in motion from right to left, but a handoff up the middle, and gaining more than enough yardage for a first down. On the handoff is, I'm trying to get a number, that's Devontae Williams again. So he got about 5 yards there. He needed three, got five, and a fresh set of downs for KCU.
Yeah, smart run right there. Devontae knowing what KCU needed for the first down there and just kind of got his shoulder square and really ran hard in there, not trying to dance or dodge right there, trying to pick up that first down.
That's right. Ball's almost at midfield. KCU first and 10 on their own 49-yard line. And here we go. Maxwell Ward takes a snap, fakes a handoff, finds a receiver in the middle of the field and got some room to run, bouncing it over toward that St. Andrews sideline. That is Keon Smith, who gets it down inside the 25. He's going to go out of bounds at about the 23-yard line. So a big play here.
Yeah, short passing game has really been effective. St. Andrews with some soft coverage, just trying to make sure they don't give up the deep stuff. And Maxwell's able to find these guys on these little short, kind of call them hunt routes. You just kind of get down in there and you find the area between the linebacker and the flat defender and just kind of hunt a spot to be open and turn around and show the quarterback your numbers. And he's able to put the ball on him and then make some yards after the catch.
A 29-yard gain there as Ward takes a snap, another fake handoff. He's going to air it out into the end zone, incomplete.
Yeah, nice job there by the safety, number 22, Nicky Walters, not biting on the play action.
That's right.
They fake it up there in Devontae, and then you got to be ready for him. So a lot of eyes on Devontae, especially early down and distance right there, and they tried to sneak a guy down the post, but Walters wasn't having it. And a good miss by Maxwell right there, able to throw the ball a little long and didn't give Walters a chance to intercept that thing. Especially
yes,
on first down, that would have been one of those bad plays that Jake was talking about earlier.
That's right.
So good decision.
On second and 10, Ward takes a snap. This time it is a handoff to Devontae Williams, who runs to his left, cuts it upfield, and he's hit after a gain of about 2 yards. I was waiting to see if maybe a flag there, because it seemed like several defenders in on that one and a little bit of a commotion, but nothing. Everything was clean. Gain of 2 yards for Devontae Williams makes it third and 8.
Yeah, Monte Williams having a really nice game there. And just as I say that, he has to go over to the boundary there. But from his inside linebacker position, he's really doing a good job of running a lot of stuff down, kind of inside out, and able to – one of the outside linebackers there sets the edge, and then Monte runs it down, able to make the play. So third down, we'll see where the Knights go back to there. We'll see that bunch formation out to the right this time for the second time.
They do that to the big side of the field quite a bit as Ward takes a snap, fakes a handoff, throws it to Taylen Rucker Daly, who's hit, but he shakes off a defender, and that's, Coach, that's a touchdown, KCU.
Yeah, Jalen Irvin, the left side defensive corner, who's made some nice plays for St. Andrews today, whiffs on the tackle, and Daly Rucker able to waltz into the end zone there. And so another quick strike, another nice drive for the Knights, and things have really opened up here in the second. After a scoreless first quarter, we are lighting up the scoreboard here in Grayson.
Yes, sir. So KCU with an answer here. That puts them ahead by 6 points. And Paul Rodriguez on the field, the PAT team, looking to make it a 7-point lead with a little under a minute and a half to go before the half. There's the snap and the kick, and it's good. So, Coach, minute 22 to go before the half. KCU, the Knights of KCU, lead the Knights of St. Andrews 21-14. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
Uncle Rick, what are you doing?
I'm trying to stay cooler in my man cave.
Well, this is a beer cave, and you can't stay in this cooler forever.
But Clark's Pub and Shop can get you through the dog days of summer.
Whether it's fountain drinks at the lowest price or you're filling up the cooler for the family and friends, Clark's has the widest selection, the best prices, and the most helpful staff you'll find anywhere.
Beat the heat at Clark's Pub and Shop.
Return, refresh, refuel.
Are you having trouble keeping your parking lot lit? Is customer safety one of your top priorities? If so, call River City's Builders at 473-4112 for all your lighting needs. We have bucket truck and boom crane truck services. We have extensive experience in exterior lighting and parking lot lighting maintenance. No need to ever be in the dark again. Remember, call River City's Builders at 473-4112 for all your lighting needs. We will light your path to success.
Back in Grayson, KCU with another lead. And, Coach, 21-14 going into the half. That's a whole lot better than 14-14. But if I'm St. Andrews right here, I'm taking some shots downfield.
Yeah, they're going to try to get this thing even back up again, especially if they get some decent field position. You know, just really impressed with KCU and how patient Maxwell Ward has been with taking the what is there. You know, what's there in the passing game. A lot of short passing. They get the kind of burst release there out of that bunch set, and a guy comes open in the flat, and Rucker able to find a way to get into the end zone.
Squib kick up the middle of the field. It goes all the way almost to the 20-yard line before it's fielded. And fielding that kick is Amori Lee, a sophomore linebacker on the kickoff return team. And he brings it ahead just a little bit. I think he got it to around the 26-yard line. So first down and 10 for St. Andrews. They've got 74 yards to go here in a minute and 17 seconds. To get some points on the board.
Yeah, nice coverage there by the kick team of Dylan DeWitt right there, freshman. Always good to see those young guys contributing on special teams right there. Gets down the field, makes a tackle, and doesn't give St. Andrews a good field position.
Ballard takes it, drops back, and he finds a receiver over in the flats. That's a Ronson Cook. I said it earlier. I'll say it again. Yep. I think those two have a bond. You see him get a lot of targets. A Ronson Cook.
Absolutely. He is their leading receiver coming into the year, and he's continued. He's got three or four catches on the day, and so they quickly get a first down and move it out, and again taking advantage of the soft coverage over there into the boundary.
Four catches for 85 yards here tonight so far, or today. As Fowler takes a snap, drops back. This time it's going to be a screen pass over to Devontae Allen. And he marches ahead, gets out of bounds, stops the clock at a minute and 4 seconds. Gain of around 6 yards on first down.
Yep. Wide stick, very, very common play around. They run slot receiver kind of to the inside. They get the back in the flat. Fowler reads it out, gets him in there.
Had some movement there on the snap, so a free play. Flag Ooh. Was thrown. And an incomplete pass. Coach, he had his receiver there, too, on that free play, just overthrew him.
Yeah, Cameron Dunklin is the guy that says the defensive end that's offsides for the Knights. He's in the neutral zone.
I don't think Fowler there was any question about that.
Yeah, there was no question about that. And he had so Fowler knew he had a free play. And he tried to get the ball out there to number three, Marquise McCoy. And he had a guy. He had a chance maybe to get that ball, but came up maybe just a step short there, kind of pulled his arms back there as he kind of felt some footsteps coming out of that KCU secondary there.
That's right. First and 10 with a minute and 1 second on the clock. 2x2 set balls on the right hash as Fowler takes the ball, drops back, and another one of those designed middle screen under pressure. And a good job there by the rushing defender there. I didn't see who it was, but he had his hands up, made it tough for Fowler to throw it. He tried to pop it up over top of him, and falls incomplete.
Yeah, really good play call there. They kind of anticipated the pressure from KCU, and so they had the screen pass set up, but Jacob Wright able to kind of get his hands as he noticed if he kind of read it out there. He stopped and was able to jump and kind of block that pass, get his hands on it, and that saved maybe a big play there for St. Andrews.
And they had success on that middle screen earlier, too.
Mm-hmm.
Three receivers to the left as Fowler drops back looking downfield. He throws it to a check down route, and he was wide open, Coach, but he dropped it.
Yeah, they had the underneath route there, the little crosser, as the linebackers kind of dropped back in coverage. Just plain and simple dropped it right there, and that would have been probably enough. Could have turned it up maybe and possibly got to the first down or close to it, but instead third and 10, and sometimes you got to catch that thing before you run with
That's
it.
That's right. That was freshman wide receiver Cam Lackey. Yeah. And probably not a lot of experience, you know, this is his first season, all that. So here we go, 2x2 set for St. Andrews on third and 10. 51.7 seconds left before the half, and KCU with a 21-14 lead. As Fowler takes a snap, drops back under pressure. He's going to take it himself, gets over to the St. Andrews sideline, and, Coach, he slung the ball there. Are we going to?
Number 10.
Yeah, I think that ball was knocked out of his hands.
Okay,
actually.
I couldn't tell. That's
he was kind of carrying it in one hand out there and trying to get a number. It looks like that might be Cameron Dunklin again, who ran him out of bounds and kind of slapped that arm from behind and caused that ball to go forward there.
He kind of chased him down there.
Yeah,
too,
he did. He kind of ran him down.
He had some room to run,
So for the third time today, the St. Andrews Knights are going to go for it here on fourth down.
And here we go. Fowler drops back to pass under pressure. He's got room to run, though, and he does just that. And he's hit as he slides. He needed 4 yards. He got 5, and probably got a little headache out of that one, too.
Yeah, he took a pretty good shot there at the end. Again, it's tough to see who got him, but to his credit, man, he popped right up, and got him back up on the ball and trying to get something done here, 30 seconds on a moving clock.
Trips to the left, Fowler directing traffic before he takes the snap. He does that, drops back. Looking downfield under a little bit of pressure, finds a check down route. That's Devontae Allen, who's got room to run inside the 20, inside the 15, still not down. And they're going to call forward progression at around the 11-yard line. So that makes it interesting here, Coach. 19.2 seconds left to go, and a first down for St. Andrews.
Yeah, and they'll also take their first time out. So a ton of room there. They just Allen leaks out of the backfield right over the middle. Turns around and Fowler able to get the ball to him, and just tons of – they sent all four receivers deep. And so the coverage had kind of gotten deep, pretty deep there.
Yeah.
And Allen all by himself underneath and takes that thing, another short pass, and scampers down to close to the about the 11-yard line there. So then they take their first time out. And they're kind of in business here, so they,
yeah.
they've got two more timeouts left, so they could still run the ball once if they wanted to. 19 seconds from the 11-yard line, you're going to get at least three plays if they're pass plays.
Yep.
So with two timeouts, so they got really have not a ton of time, but they have enough time probably to get three plays off here.
Absolutely. And,
So be interesting. You can't just sit on the pass here. They'll be able to run it. And one of the things you worry about here is just as they get so spread out is you worry about Fowler pulling it down and running it in from here.
Oh, yeah. And that's he's done it twice on this drive. And something, too, Coach, first and 10 from the 11, they still have enough room for a first down without a touchdown. But with only three plays left, that probably, won't be that big of a factor.
That's not a factor. The thing that's going to be interesting, I'm anxious to see here is how the defensive staff from KCU is going to play this here.
Yeah.
You know, trying to see what personnel is going to come out for the St. Andrews Knights. And if they're going to go with a heavy personnel package, or are they going to go – 10, and then whether the Knights will blitz, where they'll bring some pressure, or they're going to drop 8 and try to keep Fowler in the pocket and have somebody kind of spying on him a little bit. So they do put the fullback in the game. So they go 20 personnel. That means they got two running backs and three receivers, no tight end. And Solomon Mitchell is that H-back fullback kind of guy at 290 pounds.
Fowler's going to take it, drop back, look to pass. And his throw was way off the mark there, Coach. It was probably 4 to 5 yards away from the receiver.
Yeah, he's just trying to get rid of that thing, Trent Hill, with quick pressure. You know, I thought they might leave Mitchell in to help kind of protect right there, but they did not. They got him out into the flat quick as they get five receivers in the route. Kind of interesting, a 290-pound receiver out in the flat there. I really thought he would be in to kind of shore up the protection, but he wasn't. They tried to leak him out in the flat, and so we're just going to flip the formation here. Solomon lines up as the H-back on the left, and they got two receivers left.
And here we go, a low snap. Fowler takes it, drops back, throws it in the back corner of the end zone. Coach, and it's picked off. Wow, what great coverage there. And an interception for KCU.
Yeah, kind of an inaccurate throw there by Fowler. Really nice coverage. I think that
J.R. Smith.
Yeah, J.R. Smith on the coverage and giving up a couple inches in height right there.
Yeah.
And made a really nice play. But the Fowler threw that ball a little too far to the inside. That ball's got to be thrown on that back pylon there. And to kind of keep from the underneath defender there, in this case, from KCU, JR being able to make a play on it.
And he's a name we've said a few times here.
Yeah.
And want to make sure we say as Maxwell Ward there takes a knee, and that means our score going into halftime, 21-14. But back to that interception, JR Smith. He was in the right place.
Oh, absolutely.
That was
great
pass coverage.
Absolutely. Great coverage. He's right on his inside hip. And if you underthrow that ball, that's what's going to happen.
Yes, sir.
You know, just kind of from the offensive perspective, I just think that thing's got to be on the back pylon where nobody gets it or your guy gets it.
Yep.
And that's a mistake. And when the offense makes a mistake, JR's right there to take care of it. But absolutely, he was in the perfect spot to play that ball.
Absolutely. So, Coach, going into halftime here, we've got a KCU lead here in the Battle of the Knights, an AAC conference game, the KCU Knights 21, the St. Andrews Knights 14. We're going to step out, and we'll be back for the halftime show right after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
When you want real, authentic Mexican menu items, you want Tres Hermanos Nunez. Accept no substitutes. None compares. Fajitas, tacos, burritos, quesadillas, chimichangas, even vegetarian choices. A kid's menu, desserts, and salads, a tasty, budget-pleasing selection for you and your family, unlike any others. Should be your first and only choice for authentic Mexican all throughout the tri-state. Ashland, Greenup, Grayson, Paintsville, Canova, South Point, Olive Hill, and Cannonsburg. Tres Hermanos Nunez, the best around.
You know, financial security begins at home with home ownership. If you've been putting off looking for a home because you think you can't afford it, you owe it to yourself to check out Members Choice Credit Union. Members Choice Credit Union has programs for first-time home buyers and more to help put you in the home of your dreams.
call, click, or stop by Members Choice Credit Union today.
Members Choice Credit Union, NMLS 411-945, Equal Housing Lender. Call for additional information. Other restrictions may apply.
In addition to the Greenup location, Stelz Pharmacy's newest location is at 437 James Hanna Drive in South Shore, but has retained the name you know and love, McDonald Pharmacy, with the same great service you'll find in the Greenup location, with free delivery service and their convenient drive-through. Get your vaccinations and allergy shots, and of course, great prescription service. At Stelz Pharmacy in Greenup and McDonald Pharmacy, James Hanna Drive, South Shore.
Stelz Pharmacy.
Uncle Rick, what are you doing?
I'm trying to stay cooler in my man cave.
Well, this is a beer cave, and you can't stay in this cooler forever.
But Clark's Pub and Shop can get you through the dog days of summer.
Whether it's fountain drinks at the lowest price or you're filling up the cooler for the family and friends, Clark's has the widest selection, the best prices, and the most helpful staff you'll find anywhere.
Beat the heat at Clark's Pub and Shop.
Return, refresh, refuel.
And we're back here in Grayson for halftime here from Kentucky Christian University as the Knights lead it 21-14, an exciting first half. It took a little while for both teams to get going offensively. We were scoreless after one quarter of play, but it didn't take long into that second quarter for KCU to put some points on the board first, and then St. Andrews with an answer. Thank you, sir. And I'll tell you real quick how we got there. To 21-14, KCU, as I mentioned, put some points on the board first in this ball game here in the second quarter, with 12:39 on the clock. KCU a 79-yard Maxwell Ward touchdown pass to Devontae Williams, a beautiful touchdown pass, a toss and a catch, and then a Paul Rodriguez PAT made the score 7-0 with 12:39 to go before the half. Then St. Andrews with an answer a few minutes later. The floodgates offensively, I guess you would say, started opening up in the second quarter. Fowler to Marquise McCoy from 11 yards out with 8:07 on the clock, and then a Cameron McFadder PAT made it 7-7. Then again in the second quarter, KCU with an answer, 5:11 on the clock. Tyler Haas, in at quarterback, rushes from 4 yards out, and a Paul Rodriguez PAT made it 14-7. Then 1 minute later, 1 minute and 2 seconds worth of football time later, St. Andrews with a big 49-yard touchdown pass from Andrew Fowler to Aronson Cook, and then a McFadder PAT made it 14-14. Going into the half with 4 minutes going into the half, and then KCU puts more points on the board right before halftime, minute and 22 seconds on the clock. Maxwell Ward throws it to Taylin Rucker Daly from 20 yards out, and then a Paul Rodriguez PAT put us where we are now on the scoreboard, 21-14. We talked in the pregame, this is an AAC game. Both teams sitting at 1-3 going into this ball game here in the Appalachian Athletic Conference. So a win here would definitely go a long way, especially in the conference standings, as the Knights so far so good for them, and getting our stats going here. A big shout out to the Sports Information Department doing the stats here for us at KCU. They bring them to us at the half, coach. And if you want to go ahead and take a look at the stats for the first half here in this ball game.
Okay, yeah. You know, most importantly, the biggest stat of all right there is that the 7-point lead, 21-14, and have been able to be kind of explosive on offense, pick up some chunk yards in the short passing game, and then turning those things into some long runs. But you take a look down through here, and KCU, 9 first downs. St. Andrews able to pick up a few more at 16. Kind of one thing that stands out here is that you know, St. Andrews has been able to rush the ball a little bit. They've 24 carries for 107 for 107 yards this year. We're talking about a team that only averages 113 yards per game through seven games. And so they've already tallied 107 yards, and that's been a big part of their success, able to keep the chains moving. That's why they have 16 first downs so far in this game. But they've not been slacking and throwing the ball either. They got another 179 yards in passing. KCU with 191. Total offense, that's 45 plays for 286 yards for that for the St. Andrews offense. Again, a team that's averaging only 256 yards a game. They're already over that season average of 256 with 286 yards. Offensively, a total plays for Kentucky Christian, only 28 plays for 207 yards, but they've got the three touchdowns. Maxwell Ward is 13 attempts, 8 completions. And he's got a touchdown to go along with that. Turnovers have been no fumbles, but St. Andrews has turned the ball over on an interception. Penalties have been relatively even, 4 penalties for each team, 27 yards for St. Andrews and only 30 yards for Kentucky Christian. Time of possession has been slightly in the favor of St. Andrews at 16 minutes and 31 seconds. Third down efficiency kind of is where this game has kind of turned so far in my mind, as St. Andrews is only 1 out of 7 on third down, and they're 3 out of 5 on fourth down, which is good, but they're not just not making enough on third down, making it very difficult for themselves to keep it moving. On the other side, KCU 3 out of 6 making half of their third down, and they've went for it one time and got it on fourth down, red zone. St. Andrews won. They got 1 score out of 2 attempts down in the red zone, but they've been inside the 30 a couple of times. It doesn't show up on the stats, and an additional couple of times. Whereas Kentucky Christian, 2 out of 2, when they get the ball in the red zone, they're able to get some points for it. That's kind of a real quick look at the team statistics. Again, the thing that kind of jumps out at me is just their ability to rush the ball so far. Like I said, 24 carries, 107 yards, and only averaging 113 on the year. So I'm sure that when they go in the locker room, that defensive staff from Kentucky Christian is going to be talking about how to get Allen and Leggett kind of slowed down a little bit and see if they can get off the field a little more on third down.
Yep, I totally agree with you there. Allen Leggett and the quarterback Fowler, too. I don't know. He's got several rushing attempts. I think he's got around, according to my account, what do you got there?
I got 10 for 42.
I got 10 for 38, so yeah. I'm not too bad.
Not too far off there. But yeah, officially 10, and he's their leading carrier, actually. He's pulled it down and made some plays in the passing game when he's had to, but he's pulled it down for 42 yards, which is, that's a good trust factor for that St. Andrews coaching staff.
Exactly.
That they can drop him back in the passing game. If nothing's there, they can trust him to pull the ball down and make something out of it.
At least get something.
That's right, at least get something out of it, not make the, not make the big mistake there. He does have an interception, as we said earlier, in the end zone, but kind of just a little bit of underthrown ball on a fade route, and a really nice play by the Kentucky Christian defensive back, JR, to make that play. As far as rushing, Allen and Leggett have kind of been the two guys. Allen's got 8 carries for 48 yards, and Leggett 5 for 18. Combine that with Fowler's carries, and that's how you get the 107 yards rushing for the St. Andrews Knights. On the other side, Maxwell Ward has kind of been the star of the show. 8 out of 13, 191 yards, and 2 touchdowns, taking care of the ball, no interceptions.
Yeah,
they've turned.
That's huge.
Absolutely. As far as rushing goes, they haven't really rushed the ball. Haven't had to rush the ball that much. They've really used the short passing game as their rushing game. They haven't thrown the ball a ton down the field, even though they've got 191 yards. A lot of that has been short throws that the receivers have turned into long gains.
That's right.
Josh Taylor does have 4 carries for 6 yards. Devontae Williams, 4 for 20. A couple other guys have a carry, including Tyler Haas, backup quarterback, come in the game in a goal line situation, kind of a wildcat package, if you will, and has the single carry for 4 yards and a touchdown. So it's great to see him, who was starting some games earlier in the year at quarterback, come in and contribute and get a touchdown that way. Receiving, Ward has really spread the ball around. Maxwell, yeah. got a bunch of guys with a catch. Devontae Williams with two catches, and Tylan Daylor Rucker with two catches also. Devontae had those two catches out of the backfield for 97 yards. One catch, one short catch that turned into a long run for 79-yard touchdown. So the other guys here all contributing. Cameron Taylor with a single catch for 8 yards. Austin Mullins with a catch that didn't get anywhere. Anderson with a catch for 6 yards. And Kean Smith, a catch for 28 yards. So a lot of guys getting involved, spreading the ball around. That makes it tough to defend. Able to kind of move the chains through that short passing game. As long as you got to credit the offensive line for keeping Max upright, keeping him on his feet, him pretty clean, and able to hit a lot of those passes.
A lot of good stats there, especially if you're a KCU fan. Mm-hmm. Coach, we're going to step out. We got a couple more breaks to get in here. At halftime, your score, KCU 21, St. Andrews 14. Back after this on the Halftime Show from Grayson, Kentucky on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
Make your everyday purchases faster, simpler, and more convenient with First National Bank's new contactless debit card, featuring a fresh new design and the ability to add your card to your phone's mobile wallet. Your debit card has never been more secure. Simply look for the contactless symbol at checkout, tap your contactless card, or hold your phone over the terminal, and your payment is processed in seconds without your card number ever being exposed. Tap, pay, go. It's that easy with First National Bank. First National Bank in Canonsburg, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Does your gas station or convenience store need a facelift? If so, call River City Builders at 473-4112 for your remedy. Big or small projects, River City's Builders is a company for all your needs. We have extensive experience in the petroleum industry, from routine gas dispenser and canopy maintenance to above ground, underground tank and piping work to full blown remodels and new builds. Call River City Builders at 473-4112 for all your petroleum needs. We'll cover your back and keep your customers pumping gas.
When you have business away from home or a planned event far from your comfort zone, you're probably going to need a little help. Let A&A Porta Potties assist you with all your portable toilet needs. Whether on a construction site, planning for an outdoor wedding, or any other outdoor event, A&A Porta Potties are here to assist you. A&A Porta Potties also rents out storage containers, office containers, cooling fans, tables, and chairs. A&A Porta Potties, there is no event too big or too small for us to accommodate you.
Kentucky Christian University is a private, not-profit university located in the beautiful foothills of eastern Kentucky. KCU offers both undergraduate and graduate programs, including the new Teacher Leader Master of Arts in Education degree. They also have an array of competitive sports. Kentucky Christian University is committed to focusing on Christ while helping students build character and prepare for their future careers. Visit kcu.edu to learn more or to schedule a visit on campus.
And we're back here in Grayson, Chauncey Griffith, Brent Terry. And while we got just a second, the Good Cheer program on the Cool Hits Gospel Channel every Wednesdays at 8 p.m. That's when the new episodes come out. They also air every Sunday morning at 8:30 on Cool Hits 105.7 FM in Ashland, Kentucky. And again, on the Gospel Channel online at noon on Sundays. They're also available at your convenience on demand at coolhits1057.com under podcasts. And on the Cool Hits app, you can get that for any device. And, Coach, it's just me on there this week, but next week got a pretty good guest coming in. You know him, Dr. Rob Lockhart, the pastor at Liberty Baptist in Canonsburg, Kentucky, a great guy. And he's got a pretty cool story. He's a good dude.
Yeah.
And the premise of the show, talk a little bit about, just share some good stories, a little good news, just bring some good cheer, just like the name says. And talk a little bit about Jesus in the process. So tune into that if you have the opportunity, or look it up on Facebook, more information. And, Coach, are you checking out some scores?
Yeah, I'll give you a little good cheer, a little good cheer from Syracuse right now. They're up 21-7 on the Clemson Tigers, right, going into halftime. Only 30 seconds left before they go to halftime there. And number 14, Syracuse, making it tough on Clemson. A lot of eyes on that game earlier.
Sir.
You know, Tennessee coming off their big win last week over Alabama, having no problem with Tennessee. UT Martin, as they're up 45-7, still in the late in the second quarter there. Same thing with Ohio State. They continue to roll along. 3 minutes to go in the second quarter there, and they're already up 26-10 on poor Iowa, who is certainly offensively deficient.
They're struggling.
They're struggling on that side of the ball. Tremendous defense. They play great defense, but not good there. Just down the road, Cincinnati up on SMU 20-7. So just a few things there from the top 25. A few other places around the country, a few games going on. It looks like Clemson's kicked a field goal there to make it 21-10. But Baylor all over Kansas. A lot of people were looking at that game today to see how that one would go. 28-3 at halftime. Also, another game in the Big Ten some local interest, maybe Indiana and Rutgers, 14-7. Indiana at halftime. Duke ahead of Miami, 14-7. So just a few things around the country to look at. The big one there that everybody will be looking at here as it moves along is that Clemson-Syracuse game. Syracuse off to a great start, 6-0. Dino Babers got those guys going. And, of course, they've traditionally give Clemson some problems. So that'll be interesting to keep an eye on, as that game certainly has playoff implications in Division I.
Absolutely. Coach, we're going to step out, take another break. We got another couple breaks to get in, but got a whole lot more football yet to come, so don't go away. We're back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
You know, financial security begins at home with home ownership. If you've been putting off looking for a home because you think you can't afford it, you owe it to yourself to check out Members Choice Credit Union. Members Choice Credit Union has programs for first-time homebuyers and more to help put you in the home of your dreams. Call, click, or stop by Members Choice Credit Union today.
Members Choice Credit Union, NMLS 411-945, Equal Housing Lender. Call for additional information. Other restrictions may apply.
When you want real, authentic Mexican menu items, you want Tres Hermanos Nunez. Accept no substitutes. None compares. Fajitas, tacos, burritos, quesadillas, chimichangas, even vegetarian choices. A kid's menu, desserts, and salads, a tasty, budget-pleasing selection for you and your family, unlike any others, should be your first and only choice for authentic Mexican all throughout the tri-state. Ashland, Greenham, Grayson, Paintsville, Canova, South Point, Olive Hill, and Cannonsburg. Tres Hermanos Nunez, the best around.
In addition to the Greenup location, Stelz Pharmacy's newest location is at 437 James Hanna Drive in South Shore, but has retained the name you know and love, McDonald Pharmacy, with the same great service you'll find in the Greenup location, with free delivery service and a convenient drive-thru. Get your vaccinations and allergy shots, and of course, great prescription service. At Stelz Pharmacy in Greenup and McDonald Pharmacy, James Hanna Drive, South Shore.
Stelz Pharmacy.
Uncle Rick, what are you doing?
I'm trying to stay cooler in my man cave.
Well, this is a beer cave, and you can't stay in this cooler forever.
But Clark's Pub and Shop can get you through the dog days of summer.
Whether it's fountain drinks at the lowest price or you're filling up the cooler for the family and friends, Clark's has the widest selection, the best prices, and the most helpful staff you'll find anywhere.
Beat the heat at Clark's Pub and Shop.
Return, refresh, refuel.
And we're back here in Grayson. Chauncey Griffith, Brent Terry, glad to have you along here at halftime. And, Coach, if you're in the locker room right now, we talked about some things maybe you would focus on coming out of the half. If you're KCU right now, we talked about that rushing attack of St. Andrews. What are you telling your team?
Well, I think that's where it starts. The defensive staff, they'll kind of get together and they'll talk about what they mean. They're only giving up 14 points, so you know they're not panicked by
exactly.
any means. You know, nothing like that. But they're gonna take a look at what they can do. Maybe with their defensive front to kind of get those guys slowed down just a little bit. They're gonna take a look at Allen when he's in. Make sure that they're focused on him when he's in the game. The other thing that they'll look at is making sure that Allen's hurt them out of the backfield in the passing game a few times too. So that will be a point of contention. But they're just going to talk about make sure that they continue to hold their gaps, that everybody stays gap sound. I think the other big thing that they'll talk about, and maybe any adjustments that we'll talk about being made, will be Fowler pulling the ball down and scrambling. They're going to want to take a look. Maybe they might consider putting somebody on Fowler in certain situations, as he's heard him kept the chains moving three or four times just by being able to pull the ball down and get something when nothing's there in the passing game. So I think those will be the big things that they'll look at, is just how they can kind of keep control of the rushing game a little bit. No need to make any huge adjustments or anything like that. They're not, they're not panicked by any means, but they'll just, take a look at what they can do to slow Devontae Allen down a little bit, and maybe Fowler when he pulls the ball down.
Now, flipping the script, if you're St. Andrews, you're down by a touchdown, KCU's had some success, and from their standpoint, the KCU defense has done a pretty good job. What are you telling your team?
Yeah, well, they're going to try to continue to run the ball, I think. I look for them to continue staying in the package with the fullback in the game and take their shots with Fowler only kind of when they feel like when they pull the KCU defense up. And if the numbers, if KCU still stays back with a lot of two deep or four deep coverage, I think they're going to try to continue to feed the ball to Leggett and Allen. They're going to try. There's no reason to abandon those guys. It's just 7 points, a lot of football left. So I think that they want to come out and try to keep moving the chains. They'd like to keep KCU's offense off the field a little bit. They've certainly been explosive, and they're kind of having the KCU offense has certainly found a rhythm, and they're starting to make more plays on that side of the ball. So it would certainly be advantageous for the Knights of St. Andrews to kind of be able to control the clock a little bit, keep getting some first downs. Like I said, they had 16 first downs in that first half, and they'd like to be able to control that ball. They had it for 16 minutes there in the first half, and so they want to keep control of the ball, keep KCU's offense off the field, and you do that with the running game and the short passing game, and Leggett and Allen will kind of be the focus of that, and they'll take their shots. They feel confident dropping Fowler back to pass, and if he doesn't have anything, he'll try to make something out of it with his feet.
Coach, sounds like a pretty good synopsis of what we got going on here. Both teams back out on the field, and man, you can just tell that KCU, the whole team, I guess, a little bit of extra pep in their step, man.
Yeah, they certainly got some confidence.
They did before the game, too, though.
Right.
It's noticeable.
Yeah, but after kind of a little bit of a slow first quarter, kind of come out, a couple punts, a fumble in the first series, get a sack and a fumble, and so a little bit of concern, but then they really felt like they caught their rhythm. Offensive football, especially this no-huddle kind of football, is a lot about rhythm. And they've been able to complete a lot of short passes, and then their receivers have been able to take those short passes and make some yards after the catch.
Yep.
And that's really important. That keeps things moving. They haven't had to run the ball a ton. They've done it just enough to keep St. Andrews from dropping eight all the time. And that's another reason that the short passing game has been pretty effective, is when St. Andrews drops eight, they are almost playing a four deep look, and there's some underneath stuff that's available when you do that. And so offensive line's been able to keep Max on his feet. He's able to find those guys. He's been really pretty accurate with those short throws, and haven't had any really any drops to speak of. The receivers have been very sure-handed. And so they found that rhythm. These up-tempo offenses need rhythm, and they've certainly got it. And I feel like they're really confident, and they fully expect to go out here and put at least another three or four scores on the board this half.
Yes, sir. Coach, we got one more break to get in, and when we return, it'll be time for some football. So we're going to step out back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
Need some extra money for home improvements or other purchases? How about a home equity line of credit with absolutely no closing costs? We have some exciting news from our loan department at First National Bank. Right now, open a home equity line of credit at First National, and we will pay all the fees at closing. Hurry into one of our 8 locations to take advantage of this great offer. First National Bank, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC.
Are you having trouble keeping your parking lot lit? Is customer safety one of your top priorities? If so, call River City's Builders at 473-4112 for all your lighting needs. We have bucket truck and boom crane truck services. We have extensive experience in exterior lighting and parking lot lighting maintenance. No need to ever be in the dark again. Remember, call River City's Builders at 473-4112 for all your lighting needs. We will light your path to success.
When you have business away from home or a planned event far from your comfort zone, you're probably going to need a little help. Let A&A Porta Potties assist you with all your portable toilet needs. Whether on a construction site, planning for an outdoor wedding, or any other outdoor event, A&A Porta Potties are here to assist you. A&A Porta Potties also rents out storage containers, office containers, cooling fans, tables, and chairs. A&A Porta Potties, there is no event too big or too small for us to accommodate you.
Kentucky Christian University is a private, not-profit university located in the beautiful foothills of eastern Kentucky. KCU offers both undergraduate and graduate programs, including the new Teacher Leader Master of Arts in Education degree. They also have an array of competitive sports. Kentucky Christian University is committed to focusing on Christ while helping students build character and prepare for their future careers. Visit kcu.edu to learn more or to schedule a visit on campus.
And we're back in Grayson. We really are back in Grayson, and sorry about that. Coach, time for some football here, and it's going to be St. Andrew's ball starting out.
Yeah, which kind of really emphasizes how important that last stop was, the interception in the end zone. If they were able to convert and get the ball back, that would have been a really big deal. So St. Andrew's will start with the ball here as we get ready in the second half.
Yeah, and a decent kickoff return here to start things out. Gets it across the 30 to about the 32-yard line, and the returner there, number 37, he's returned a couple. That's Eldrick Williams, and sets his team up for some decent field position here starting out the second half.
Yeah, I always like to pay close attention here early in the second half. These are some of the things that whatever was talked about at halftime are going to kind of manifest here early in this first drive. We'll see what they talk about, what they think they can get accomplished here offensively, and see if we'll see anything different out of St. Andrews.
You always talk about that first drive after halftime kind of setting the tone here, so we'll find out. Fowler steps back to pass, finds a receiver that's Leggett in the flats, and he gets some yards, about three, maybe two, maybe three. Not much happening there on first down.
Yeah, so they set up in a run-heavy formation with a fullback at 20 personnel. We've talked about a couple times. They set up in a run-heavy formation and then get the tailback out in the flat. Fowler able to find him there. So just a nice control pass there into the flat and able to get a few yards as they get this drive started.
Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball's on the right hash. Two receivers on the short side of the field. And Fowler takes the snap, throws it to one of those receivers. That's Aronson Cook, who's closest to the sideline. He marches ahead. He's knocked out of bounds around the 45, maybe 44-yard line, but enough for a first down.
Yeah, again, that's a play we've seen several times out of them where they just – that's the play they scored on the long pass earlier in the game where basically just Fowler takes the snap, flicks it out to Cook into the boundary. He just takes a one-step kind of hitch route, catches that, squares his shoulders, catches that thing, and then turns the ball upfield. They usually try to get the slot defender out on the corner to help block him, and it basically just like a long handoff.
Yeah, and he got what he needed there for a first down. St. Andrews, Fowler takes a snap, looks again over toward the flats. This time he throws it to the big receiver. That's number 80, Todrick Walker, and he gets it out to the numbers after a gain of about 4 yards.
So, you think, well, what did they talk about at halftime? Obviously, it looks like they've talked about maybe trying to exploit the area, the flats, or trying to pick on maybe the outside linebackers of KCU a little bit. They might feel like they have some matchups there. So, already we've seen two or three throws into the flats here to get this half started.
Fowler takes the snap, hands it. No, he's going to keep it himself up the middle, gains a couple yards. And makes it third down and about five, we'll say, third down and maybe 4 yards after the two-yard pickup.
Yeah, one of the St. Andrews linemen a little bit slow getting up. We'll see where they have to bring him out of the game or not here on the crucial third down. Looks like he's going to stay in the game, though.
We have a receiver coming off. That's Dante Crowder. Coming back on is Cam Lackey, the freshman wide receiver. He dropped a pass earlier.
Yeah, and that was Tristan Brown that was slow to get up. And he's their center. That's the reason I was waiting to see if he was going to be able to stay in the game or not.
Yeah, that probably has something to do with why he did.
Yeah.
I think. Two receivers to the big side of the field for St. Andrews as Fowler goes through his cadence. And do we have a timeout?
Well, I was watching their coach where he was doing his best to try to get a timeout before the play clock ran out. And the back judge threw the penalty, but I believe they're going to give him the timeout.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And I think that's the right call
there.
I was watching the coach, and he was trying to get the side judge's attention there, and he finally got it right the last minute. And so they'll give him the timeout, and I think that's the right call.
Yeah, absolutely. So 12:38 on the clock here in the third quarter. KCU still leads this ball game 21-14. St. Andrews with the football, third down, 4 yards to go on their own 49-yard line, so right at midfield. And coach, obviously, wasn't planned timeout. But if you're over there on that St. Andrews sideline with your team in these circumstances, what are you telling them?
Well, I think that they took the timeout just because they know how important this third down is. They don't want to put themselves into a situation where they have to go for it here in the middle of the field. But at the same time, they really don't want to give the ball back to KCU, and they don't want to lose touch with them. If they get down 14 points, I feel like they're not very explosive on offense. You know, even though they've put 14 points on the board here in the first half of this game, you know, like I said, they're only averaging 10 points a game.
Right.
They did have a scoreless first quarter. So, you know, they don't want to lose touch. They think it's really important to kind of keep the chains moving here. And they don't want to put themselves in a position where they have to go for it and give KCU a short field. But I think they're just worried about KCU being in rhythm on offense, and they felt like it was important enough to take an early timeout in order to get this first down.
Third down and 4 yards to go. Both teams back on the field. 2-by-2 set for St. Andrews. Running back goes in motion as Fowler drops back, and his pass is knocked away. Great pressure there. I didn't see who got the hand on it, but several defenders in the backfield. It's going to make it fourth down and 4 yards.
Yeah, Derek Houston coming off the edge right there. They decide to bring pressure. They try to set up a screen pass out in the left flat, a place they've attacked a few times early in this half. But Derek gets his hands up and knocks that down and going to force a punt.
I believe the first punt we've seen, Coach, from St. Andrews here right at midfield.
Yep.
And that does go to show that, like you said, maybe a little bit of worry about that KCU offense.
Yeah.
The punt, was there a fair catch, I think, at the 21?
Well,
I didn't see.
No, the ball hit really short and bounced.
Okay.
Took a KCU bounce
back.
It was kind of a short punt. It was a high punt, but pretty short. And able to it took a KCU bounce, and one of the St. Andrews cover men able to down it there around the 38-yard line.
So good field position. I feel like the whole game's been played from like 30 to 30 or something. That, and a lot of it's been played here in the middle of the field. But
yeah.
Good field position here for the Knights starting out. Maxwell Ward behind the center in the gun hands it off up the middle, and charging forward is – is that Gerald Daniels?
It is Gerald
Daniels.
Okay,
okay.
Yeah.
Still Gerald, waiting on to see a number, but
yeah.
I just thought it looked like him.
Gerald, 5'8", 157 pounds or so, but
yeah.
he is thick thighed, and he really runs hard when he gets the shoulder square down in there. So a lot of people contributing to this KCU offense right now, and that's a great run on first down.
No doubt about it, Coach. Tied in to the left, two receivers to the left as well. Ball's close to the middle of the field. And a fake handoff and then a throw downfield. And, Coach, we had some pretty good pass coverage there from St. Andrews. A little bit of contact, but nothing dirty or anything like that.
That's safety Nikki Walters coming over on the coverage. In case you try to take advantage of that good first down run by faking the ball in there, trying to get a little play action pass. But Walters done a nice job a couple times today, staying back, playing his coverage, having good eye discipline, and cutting off that route. He was able to what we call cap that route, and he just kind of cut it off and made the ball be overthrown.
That was Austin Mullins there, was a targeted receiver. We haven't seen him with a catch yet today, but usually a contributor to the offense here. 2-by-2 set as Ward steps back, finds a receiver in the flats on an out route. That's K. Ron Taylor, who gets out of bounds. And I anticipate that'll be a first down KCU. Yes,
that's
sir.
That's a really accurate, really nice throw on third and six right there, picking up seven, six and a half, seven, a really accurate throw for Maxwell on the out route.
Yes.
You know, defended fairly well, but that's how you keep the chains moving, and that short passing game is added again.
First and 10 from their own 48-yard line for KCU. Three bunch receivers over to the right, and ball's on the left hash, so Ward's going to take the snap, fake a handoff. Got a defender to bite on that, and he's going to take it and run himself over to his own sideline. And we've got a flag over on the sideline there, Coach. We got a little scuffle as Ward ran out of bounds. So did the defenders. Got a little, getting a little chippy over there on the sideline.
Yeah, Jalen Irvin and one of the KCU receivers were kind of tangled up there, and Irvin had a face full of a hand full of face mask. And I don't know if that's what they're going to call just yet, but he definitely had the KCU receiver by the face mask and jerked him out of bounds there. And as they kind of scuffled their way all the way over into the bench area.
We'll see right here what the call is.
Dead ball, personal foul.
Got a personal foul on St. Andrews and a personal foul on Kentucky Christian University, so those will offset. We're not down there. We don't know what was said, and you know the whole story. But from where we're sitting, definitely saw that hand on that face mask.
Yeah. He not only had a handful of that face mask, but he also was pulling and jerking on it. Leading him around by that face mask. I'm surprised that we ended up with offsetting penalties there.
Same. Second down and 11 yards to go now as Ward ran out of bounds about a yard before the marker. And here we go on second and 11. Ward's going to take it, fake a handoff. He's going to air it out downfield. He's got a receiver open, ball just a bit too far out of reach for Keon Smith. And it's going to fall incomplete. And, Coach, we've got more flags flying out here in the middle of the field around the offensive defensive line there.
Yeah, I kind of had my eyes still downfield there. I didn't see exactly what happened. I was looking at Tedrick Spicer on the coverage for St. Andrews, but definitely the wide receiver there, number 88, Keon Smith, had a step on him, and Maxwell just kind of led him just a little bit too far, and I was kind of watching those guys, as you pointed out, that we had a little scuffle here in the middle of the field, and so we've had a couple of these situations here as things have gotten a little bit chippy between these two teams, highly competitive.
Yes, sir. It looked like some jawing back and forth for sure. We're going to find out here. Got another dead ball, personal foul on St. Andrews. And we've got a dead ball, personal foul on Kentucky Christian University. The penalties will offset.
Dead ball, personal foul called on both teams are offsetting.
So it's going to be third down and 11 for KCU. That's correct?
Mm-hmm. Be third down. You know, interestingly enough, they haven't called any of these penalties unsportsmanlike. They haven't given that unsportsmanlike. When you do that, if you get two unsportsmanlikes on the same player, then they're ejected from the game. So we're not getting a number on these. We don't know who they're calling on, but neither of them has been designated as unsportsmanlike penalties.
You're right. Third and 11 here. Maxwell Ward takes the shotgun snap, drops back, looks downfield. He's got a receiver open. Again, this time it's a catch. Looked like the same play there, Coach. Different receiver, though. K'Ron Taylor with a huge catch. And that's going to bring the football down inside it was right on the 25-yard line.
Yeah, one of the few times we've seen him kind of connect for a long pass play there.
Yeah
that ball thrown 25-30 yards in the air. Great protection. KCU able to protect Maxwell right there. Line does a good job keeping him upright. St. Drew's only rushes three.
Back on the ball quick. Ward takes the snap, trips to his left. He's under pressure, sprints out to his right, and he's going to throw it away.
Yeah, he had Gerald Daniels there in the area, and he was kind of forced out of the pocket to the right. Didn't have anywhere to go through that ball at Gerald's feet there just to keep from getting the grounding call. But a big play there. That was a third and five, big play. A lot of, you know, some jawing and getting chippy right there. So that was a big third down. Didn't want to have to punt that ball from the middle of the field. But we get it down inside the 20, around the 25-yard line now. Second down and 10. Looking to put some more points on the board. Two scores would really make it tough on St. Andrews, I think.
Yeah, I think you're right. Running back offset to the left of Ward is Gerald Daniels, and Ward's going to sprint out under pressure, throw it downfield out of bounds. Incomplete.
Yeah, I think he just kind of threw that ball away.
Yeah, he did.
Really nobody open. They moved the pocket to the left, kind of avoid some of that pressure. And good decision.
Yep.
Early in the down distance there, second down, no reason to force it. It's the third and 10. Probably have two downs to get it. I don't know. It depends on what maybe they pick up here, whether they would kick a field goal or not. But we'll see what third and 10. They kind of stay with that same 10 personnel grouping. They've got number five, Gerald Daniels, in the backfield right now.
So here we go. Receiver goes in motion from right to left. A collision in the backfield, a miscommunication, but a wheel route to Cameron Arthur, who's going to march it ahead over toward the KCU sideline for about 5 yards there, Coach. And a miscommunication, and they turned that into a positive a gain anyway.
Yeah, the running back and receiver, the jet motion and the running back collide right in front of the quarterback where he's trying to play fake to one of them, but they both stay on their feet, and he gets the ball out in the flat there. And so a gain of about five, and so they'll forgo the field goal.
Yes, sir.
In the opportunity to take a chance here on fourth down.
Fourth and five, trips to the right. Ward takes it, sprints out to his right, finds a receiver in the flats, and it's caught. And that's a first down there. K'Ron Taylor with another big-time catch on this drive. That moves the chains and gives KCU a fresh set of downs.
So a really nice third down conversion by Taylor earlier. Now a fourth down conversion where he's able to get himself open. And
yep.
Maxwell finds one of his favorite targets there, sure-handed. Taylor gets the ball down to around the 10-yard line.
Running back Gerald Daniels comes off. Terrence Carter comes on. So he's going to be the back offset to the left of Maxwell Ward. The ball's on the right hash. We've got trips to the left, three receivers. And Ward takes a snap. He's going to sprint out toward those three receivers. And nothing downfield open, so he's going to take it himself inside the five and forced out of bounds. Coach, no, that's a touchdown. Wow. I thought he was going out of bounds at the one, but he extended those arms forward with the football, hit the pylon, touchdown, KCU. Wow.
Yeah, so for the third time in a row there, they moved the pocket.
Yeah.
And that time, Maxwell, who's really not known for his running ability, pulled that thing down, makes a couple guys miss. A little collision there right at the goal line and the pylon. And
Coach, the sideline has turned into the Maxwell Ward fan club over here.
Yeah,
everybody over there,
yeah.
Man. That's great. And
so kind of as everything's going on, KCU lines up in the muddle huddle, right, where we offset most of the guys to one side or the other, and they try to sneak in a two-point conversion on St. Andrews, but their heads up as they tackle Tyler Haas there in the backfield, so they don't get the two, and so it makes it a 27-14 game instead of a 28-27 game.
Right. So – with 9:14 on the clock, Coach, 27-14 KCU leads. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
Jennifer Epperly, loan officer at First National Bank in Canonsburg. I personally invite you and all local businesses to visit our beautiful new building in Canonsburg on U.S. Route 60 next to the Walmart entrance. We offer many services including personal, mortgage, and business loans. First National Bank is locally owned by the McGuire family of Ashland and has been in business since 1902. We aim to give you the personal attention and best customer service there is to offer. Come inside, talk with us, and let us make you a part of the First National Bank family. First National Bank, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC.
Kentucky Christian University is a private, nonprofit university located in the beautiful foothills of eastern Kentucky. KCU offers both undergraduate and graduate programs, including the new Teacher Leader Master of Arts in Education degree. They also have an array of competitive sports. Kentucky Christian University is committed to focusing on Christ while helping students build character and prepare for their future careers. Visit kcu.edu to learn more or to schedule a visit on campus.
And the kick is bobbled here after the touchdown. Fielding it there around the 20-yard line was Cam Lackey. Dropped it, picked it up, and he's hit right around the – where I think the ball is going to be spotted where? At the 22, something like that, Coach. So momentum going KCU's way yet again.
Absolutely. All the momentum on their side. Sidelines fired up, everybody jumping around. you know, that and over on that other sideline, the body language is not good. They're a little, they're a little rattled over there right now, and so this is a big series for St. Andrews. If they can't find some way to get the ball down here and cut this back down to a one score game, then they're going to be in danger of getting run out of here.
Yep. As Fowler takes the snap, looks downfield. He's got a receiver open, and that's a catch there by number three, Marquise McCoy. And a big gain here. They got, ball goes from the 23 of St. Andrews down to the, where are they going to spot? The 35, I think. Yeah, the 35. So a 42-yard pickup.
Yeah, so right off the bat, they kind of felt that momentum too. Felt like they had to get themselves something going there. Fowler finds Marquise McCoy down the middle of the field. There's the quick throw out to Arroyo again, or excuse me, out to Cook again, and they do a nice job of picking up some yards on that play. They almost use it like a perimeter run play. Anytime they get soft coverage, they just zip it out there and take the 3 or 4 yards.
Yeah, 3 yards on first down is a good thing.
Yeah.
Second down, 7 yards to go here for St. Andrews as Andrew Fowler in the gun, a running back offset to his left and an H-back to his left as well. He takes a snap, drops back, looking downfield. He's going to air it out, and that's going to be a catch, a touchdown by Marquise McCoy. But, Coach, do we have no touchdown?
Now, so they've used McCoy over there a couple times in this drive. They hit two big pass plays to him on two different KCU defenders. So they use his size and speed, and Fowler puts the ball right on the money. And so, you know, just as I was saying, if they don't go down and score, you know, kind of keep themselves attached here, it was going to get tough. But they certainly answered the bell, and they answered it fast right there. I think 3 plays.
Yeah.
They get the ball right. 3 plays, 3 pass plays, 3 complete passes, and they're right down there in it. And so they convert the extra point, and so that's going to make it 21-27.
So with 8:31 to go here in the third quarter, 27-21, KCU leads St. Andrews. KCU gets a football after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
You know, financial security begins at home with home ownership. If you've been putting off looking for a home because you think you can't afford it, you owe it to yourself to check out Members Choice Credit Union. Members Choice Credit Union has programs for first-time homebuyers and more to help put you in the home of your dreams. Call, click, or stop by Members Choice Credit Union today.
Members Choice Credit Union, NMLS 411-945, Equal Housing Lender. Call for additional information. Other restrictions may apply.
When you want real, authentic Mexican menu items, you want Tres Hermanos Nunez. Accept no substitutes. None compares. Fajitas, tacos, burritos, quesadillas, chimichangas, even vegetarian choices. A kid's menu, desserts, and salads. A tasty, budget-pleasing selection for you and your family, unlike any others. Should be your first and only choice for authentic Mexican all throughout the tri-state. Ashland, Greenham, Grayson, Paintsville, Canova, South Point, Olive Hill, and Cannonsburg. Tres Hermanos Nunez, the best around.
Here's your score. KCU leads St. Andrews with 8:31 to go here in the third quarter. And the kickoff is in the air. It's a pooch kick over toward that looks like Calvin Brown over there who caught that one. And I heard a couple whistles there. I thought maybe a flag or something.
Yeah, I didn't see. I did not see Calvin make a fair catch signal.
I didn't either.
But the line judge blew it dead anyway.
Yeah.
He just kind of stood there like he did make a fair catch signal. I think the line judge just thought he was giving himself up there. But anyway, St. Andrews with a really quick strike there on offense. They use 3 plays. They go to McCoy on the post, and then Cook with a little short route, and then McCoy again with just a go route right down the boundary, and Fowler puts it on him, and just like that, they get within 7.
There we go. Maxwell Ward drops back. He's going to air it out downfield. He's got a receiver, but overthrows his guy. Goes incomplete. That was Keon Smith downfield. And, Coach, it looked like a post route maybe in the middle of the field. And he was open.
Yeah, they just got a one-on-one match up there against they get that matchup against Jalen Irvin there, and a matchup they tried to take advantage of a couple times today.
Yep.
And he did have a step on him, but Maxwell not able to hook up.
So second down and 10 yards to go here from their own 31-yard line. Maxwell Ward takes the snap under a little bit of pressure, steps forward in the pocket, and he's going to be intercepted. Threw it right into the hands of outside linebacker Trevor Collins. So a turnover here. That's the first one for KCU in this ball game, and a little bit of life on the St. Andrews sideline.
Yeah,
over there.
Devin Turner with the quick pressure up the middle forces Maxwell to kind of step to his right and kind of bearing down on him from behind. Ward throws back across his body and throws it right into the arms of Trevor Collins, who makes the catch and sets the Andrews St. Andrews Knights up with pretty good field position. And their offense is kind of hot themselves right now. After a three-play drive here, they come back with a chance to take the lead here.
First and 10 for St. Andrews from the KCU 34-yard line. And here we go. Fowler in the gun, running back offset to his right. He's going to hand it off to that running back. That's Devontae Allen who charges ahead. He gets it back to the line of scrimmage, picks up a yard, but that's it. Second and 9.
Yeah, running behind big Solomon Mitchell there. We've talked about him a couple of times. They've got Allen and Mitchell in the game together, so they choose to run in behind Mitchell there, who's a good guy to run behind.
Oh,
290 pounds. Same personnel grouping. They get lined up, and they've got that same matchup over here with McCoy. But it looks like KCU going to shade a safety that way to try to take that throw away.
Fowler throws it into the flats. It's caught. This time Marquise McCoy makes another grab. He's got two touchdowns here tonight, and he's a big contributor to that offense. Big body wide receiver. He's listed at 210 pounds. We don't have their heights, but my opinion, 6'3", what would you
6'4".
Say? I was going to say 6'4", 6'5".
Yeah.
big-time receiver.
Yeah, he's a tough matchup for Tedrick Spicer there on that side. So, you know, they tried to shade the safety to his side, and they try to double cover him right there, and he pushes down the field but runs a nice comeback route, you know, as KCU didn't want to give up the long one there.
Fowler hands it off to Devontae Allen here on third down. They need a yard, and it's going to be close. He got it back to the line of scrimmage, but – we might have fourth down here, Coach.
Yeah, Cameron Dunklin with a really sure tackle right there coming off the edge.
Yeah.
Able to beat the block from the right tackle right there, number 62, Nicholas Hendrick, and grabbed Allen by the back of the pads there, was able to get him down really quick, and so that's going to set up a really critical fourth down here.
Interesting, on fourth down and one, Big Solomon goes off, and fullback Justin Fortner comes on. He's much short. He's a whole lot shorter. He's listed at 195 pounds, so interesting. Fowler takes a snap. It's going to be a pass. Throws it into the flats. A one-on-one matchup and a one-handed interception. Wow. And off to the races is C.J. Cutliff down the sideline. Crosses the 30. He got one man to beat. He shakes him off. 10-5 touchdown, KCU. Wow. Wow.
So they end up. The KCU defense lines up really with press coverage. They go zero, man-to-man, anticipating the run. And St. Andrews tries to counter by taking advantage of a one-on-one matchup out there, and he floats the ball out. And there's a lot of contact between those guys, a lot of hand fighting between both the both players out there. But the nice one-handed interception, and he turns around and takes it to the house for the touchdown.
We'll say that was around an 80-yard interception return down that St. Andrews sideline. I don't know exactly, but that was huge.
Yeah, both CJ and the receiver both had a lot of hand fighting right there as that ball's in the air. The officials let it go, and he's able to make an outstanding one-handed interception, and then to take it, then the presence of mind to get spun around and take it down the boundary for 80-yard interception return, 79, 80-yard interception return.
Yes, sir.
And that's a game changer.
6:01 to go here in the third quarter. Your score, KCU 34, St. Andrews 21 in the Battle of the Knights. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
You know, financial security begins at home, with home ownership. If you've been putting off looking for a home because you think you can't afford it, you owe it to yourself to check out Members Choice Credit Union. Members Choice Credit Union has programs for first-time homebuyers and more to help put you in the home of your dreams. Call, click, or stop by Members Choice Credit Union today.
Members Choice Credit Union, NMLS 411-945, Equal Housing Lender. Call for additional information. Other restrictions may apply.
When you want real, authentic Mexican menu items, you want Tres Hermanos Nunez. Accept no substitutes. None compares. Fajitas, tacos, burritos, quesadillas, chimichangas, even vegetarian choices. A kid's menu, desserts, and salads. A tasty, budget-pleasing selection for you and your family, unlike any others. Should be your first and only choice for authentic Mexican all throughout the tri-state. Ashland, Greenham, Grayson, Paintsville, Canova, South Point, Olive Hill, and Cannonsburg. Tres Hermanos Nunez, the best around.
Caught around the 40-yard or 30-yard line, excuse me. It's brought across the 40-yard line by Antarius Carpenter. First time we've said his name, but he's going to be knocked out of bounds around the 40-yard line. That's where St. Andrews will take over, Coach, with 5:56 to go here in the third quarter.
Yeah, some big plays in both directions early in this third quarter. They've had a quick three-play touchdown drive early in the quarter by St. Andrews. They're moving the ball back down the field, but the Knights answer with a 80-yard pick six, and so they're right back up on the back out on the field. A lot of momentum. They're excited. The official trying to get the play clock reset.
Okay, I couldn't tell what was happening there.
Yeah, he's trying to reset the play clock as we get ready to go here. So a lot of momentum on that KCU side after that pick six, and they're going to get after him again.
Two receivers to the right, an H-back to the right as well, and a throw out of the backfield. It's going to go to, that's number 87, that's Dante Crowder in the flats, who marches ahead for a gain of about, we'll say, 5, maybe 6 yards on first down.
Zach Thomas out of the linebacking core there on the coverage, and a really nice, sure, open field tackle there, able to limit the yardage there.
So clock running here down to 5:20 and still going, and here we go. Fowler's going to take the snap, throws it right in the middle of the field off the hands of Dante Crowder. It was a check down route right in the middle of the field, about 5 yards past the line of scrimmage. Coach hit him in the hands and hit the ground wide open.
Threw his hands and right off his face mask, as a matter of fact.
Oh, did it? Okay. I thought he just had stone hands.
It went through those hands and right off his face mask.
Oh, that's
and,
even worse.
That would have been enough yards for a first down, and St. Andrews Knights have suffered from a couple of drops this game.
So third down and 4 yards to go for St. Andrews. Andrew Fowler, the quarterback, running back to his left, and he drops back the pass. It looks that way. Has a receiver downfield open, but decides to take it himself. He's under some pressure and gets enough down the KCU sideline for a first down. Pick up of maybe 5 or 6.
Yeah, really nice decision. I thought that they had number four, the wide receiver out here on the right. That's Cook and Aronson Cook. And if he had just kind of continued his route, he might have been open there as the Fowler pulled it down. But he cut his route off and kind of forced Fowler. He wanted to throw it to him and forced him into kind of running that. But he got the first down, and St. Andrews on the move again.
First and 10, Fowler takes a snap, fakes a handoff, drops or hit as he throws, and Coach, I thought it was going to be an incomplete pass, but it was a fumble, and it's recovered by KCU. I thought his arm was moving forward, but no, the ball was knocked out of his hand, and it skated forward. KCU, I'm going to say KCU fell on it last, but we don't have an official confirmation yet.
Yeah, nobody's really made it. Nobody blew a whistle, and the ball continued to be played there.
Now,
and
it's over here by the KCU sideline.
And it's going to be KCU football.
Yes, sir. I think that's a good call. I really do.
Yeah, I would like to see a replay on it. I would love to see that, but he was definitely, as he was throwing that ball, it was really close, whether it was knocked out of his hand just as he threw it. But there was definitely some contact there, and the ball went forward.
It did.
You know, but it must have been the old, you know, ball in the hand, the open hand,
yep.
Whether he had control of the ball. But the ball was definitely pushed forward about 10 yards, and there was kind of a scramble ensued for the ball, and I don't know who got on it, but it was right on the boundary. And so there were a bunch of guys after it. But nevertheless, with no replay here in this level of college football, KCU's back out on the field with the ball.
On first down, Ward throws it ahead to Devontae Williams on a little, what do you call that route there, Coach?
Yeah, just a little wide receiver comeback there.
A little one-step
route, and he kind of brings it in. It's almost like a jailbreak screen.
Yeah.
And, you know, they kind of sprint away from it, try to catch it in one-on-one coverage. He tries to get back in behind those linemen as he crosses the field. So they pick up some 10 yards.
About 12.
Yeah, about 12 yards on it. They go get a new set of downs there. A good pickup on first down.
Absolutely, first and 10.
And we've seen Devontae lined up in the backfield a lot this year, but we've also seen him in this game lined up as a receiver a lot.
Yeah, he's a jack of all trades.
Yep.
On first down,
and he's
Max
open
Moore
again.
Throws it downfield, and it's just out of the reach, Coach, of Aron. Who is that?
That's Devontae.
It's Devontae again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and we've got a flag thrown down there, too.
Yeah, I think they might get number 26 from St. Andrews. That's Tedrick Spicer. I think he might have had a little jersey tug on Devontae as he was going down the field there, and that may have been why that pass was just overthrown by a step. They're going to get Spicer for holding.
Okay.
So that's going to move him forward, and that should give him another first down. And, you know, it's probably a good thing he tugged on that jersey a little bit, or that might have been six more for the Knights.
Yeah, I think you're probably right. Yeah. First down and 10 yards to go from the St. Andrews 44-yard line for KCU. Trips to the right. Maxwell Ward takes a snap, and it's a little shovel pass straight ahead. Not much doing there. No gain, maybe even a loss of one for Gerald Daniels.
Austin Hunt, inside linebacker there from St. Andrews, not fooled on the play at all. Makes a nice high tackle.
Yeah.
Wraps him up for no gain. Austin, a senior, made a couple of tackles today. We've called his name a couple times, and he was all over that one.
So second down, 10 yards to go.
And that's one of those plays to kind of, it almost serves as a draw play to kind of slow down the rush or any blitz, kind of a blitz control play.
And it kind of works out as a run, too.
Mm-hmm.
Ward takes a snap, looks downfield, has a receiver. That's Keon Smith, who brings it inside the 20-yard line. A little slant route there in the middle of the field. He was wide open.
Yeah, really, really impressive throw there by Maxwell. Monte Wright came off the left edge basically untouched. Offensive right side basically untouched. Just beat his man out of his stance. Had a great get-off right there. Maxwell stepped up in the pocket and delivered that ball right in the breadbasket for a nice little slant, a catch, and run.
Brought down right at the 20-yard line, and the clock's rolling here. We're under 3.5 to go. KCU on the move. Maxwell Ward fakes a handoff, bootleg, sprints out, finds a receiver in the flats. That's going to be Somi Azubuki, and he brings it down inside the 5, Coach.
Yep.
I think he went out of bounds about the 3-yard line there.
Yeah. So they've been able to run the ball a little bit, so they fake the run and boot that thing back out to the right. They bring Azubuki into the right flat. Big catch for the big man, the tight end right there, able to turn it up, and almost got himself into the end zone there. That'd been fun to see him score.
Yeah, we're going to have first and goal here from the 3-yard line, and here we go. Got a new quarterback in. That's Tyler Haas. He's going to take it himself. Coach, he's hit right before he gets the goal line, bounces off. Touchdown, KCU.
Right, second time we've seen Tyler in there in the goal line situation in that Wildcat package or Wild Knight package, whatever they call it. And able to kind of, again, that gives you an extra lead blocker. And you got a couple guys in the backfield you can give it to, or Tyler can take it himself as he's done. And that's his second touchdown of the day, and it's great to see him contribute.
Got a muddle huddle again, but this time they're going to run over and get lined up here. Has Paul Rodriguez on to tack on one more point here with 2:53 to go in the third quarter. KCU now with a 3-score lead. The snap, the kick, and that one is good. So Paul Rodriguez tacks on one more. That makes it 41-21 with 2:53 to go here in the third quarter. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
I'm trying to stay cooler in my man cave.
Well, this is a beer cave, and you can't stay in this cooler forever.
But Clark's Pub and Shop can get you through the dog days of summer.
Whether it's fountain drinks at the lowest price or you're filling up the cooler for the family and friends, Clark's has the widest selection, the best prices, and the most helpful staff you'll find anywhere.
Beat the heat at Clark's Pub and Shop.
Return, refresh, refuel.
Are you having trouble keeping your parking lot lit? Is customer safety one of your top priorities? If so, call River City's Builders at 473-4112 for all your lighting needs. We have bucket truck and boom crane truck services. We have extensive experience in exterior lighting and parking lot lighting maintenance. No need to ever be in the dark again. Remember, call River City's Builders at 473-4112 for all your lighting needs. We will light your path to success.
Back here in Grayson, 41-21, your score. KCU leads St. Andrews in the Battle of the Knights, Coach. And Paul Rodriguez set to kick off here. St. Andrews getting the football back. And that kick's going to go inside. I think if he wouldn't have caught it, it would have landed in the end zone. But nonetheless, fielded around the two-yard line. And great job there by the kickoff team getting downfield. Returner there brought down about the 15-yard line. And
that's Derek Houston there on the big stop, a guy that plays a lot, regular down and distance in that regular defensive package, and also contributing on special teams and getting down there, really getting him bottled up and got him inside the 15-yard line. Really deep kickoff there by Rodriguez.
Yeah, it was.
He's done a lot of pooch kicks and a lot of different things. They've shown St. Andrews a lot of different looks on kickoff. And so they popped that one deep and able to pin them in there deep. And St. Andrews really in a world of hurt here. Down 20, 41-21, just 2 minutes to go in this quarter. And so they got a big hole to dig out of.
So first and 10, they've got the ball over on the left hash, moving left to right on the radio dial from where we're sitting up here in the press box. Trips to the right for the offense. And a handoff on first down is going to go to Leggett. He tries to get the edge, not able to do so. Tried for a stiff arm there, and we've got a flag on the tackle. I'm not sure what it's going to be.
I think they're going to get Brian Hughes there for a horse collar.
That's the only thing. Yeah.
Yeah, I think so. He kind of comes out of the secondary, runs the alley. We'll call running the alley, just kind of those, downhill on either side, kind of outside the tackle box, and makes a really nice play, but kind of got him by the. Anytime you drag somebody, it's a player safety rule, and he kind of drug him down.
He kind of rode him to the ground almost,
from behind and kind of got his legs behind him. And so when a guy goes down backwards like that, if you're anywhere near that shoulder pad, inside the shoulder pad or around the nameplate on the jersey, then you're going to get called for a horse collar. So just unfortunate there, but that'll move the ball out to about the 33 for St. Andrews.
First and 10, yes, sir, on the 33 as Fowler takes a snap, drops back, throws it to the flats, out of his reach, but he's hit as he tried to make the catch there. A great defensive play there from Tomichael Shellman, the cornerback there, coming up and sticking that receiver.
Yeah, Shellman there sees that play all the way, and as second time they've tried to sneak the running back into the flat, and Shellman breaks on it, and he's got his head turned looking at the ball, and Shellman about cuts him in half there.
Clock at 2:27 here after the incomplete pass. 2x2 set as Fowler takes it, and he's going to hand it off this time to Leggett again up the middle, who's going to march ahead, gets it almost to midfield. Brought down about the 47-yard line, so about a 15-yard pickup, enough for a first down. St. Andrews.
Yeah, really nice cut by Leggett right there, kind of stretching the ball to the left, sticks his foot in the ground, squares his shoulders, and gets the ball up the field more in the left B gap area. It looked like that play was headed outside, but he cut it back really nice and kind of caught the KCU defense over pursuing just a little bit and made a nice run.
First down, 10 yards to go as St. Andrews runs a no-huddle offense too. And here we go. Fowler takes the snap, hands it off to Leggett again up the middle. He bounces off one would-be tackler. A couple of guys with a hold of his legs there. And he's brought down after a pickup of about 3 yards.
Yep. So they'll bring Allen in now to give Leggett a little bit of a break. Leggett with a few nice carries,
yep.
And they're trying to move the ball. And honestly, KCU not too concerned about these kind of runs here.
That's right.
Kind of keeping everything in front of them right here. They don't want to give up the big shot play right here. So, but the second and seven.
And here we go. Fowler takes the snap. It's going to be a handoff. This time it's going to go to Allen, who tries to get the edge. And what a play there.
Yeah.
C.J.
Cutliff, who's already made a big impact on this play with the pick six, comes up out of the secondary right there and makes a nice low tackle on Allen.
Coach, we've got a KCU knot down over here toward the sideline. That's freshman linebacker Justin Lewis. Looks like he's holding his lower leg as the training staff goes out. So with 1 minute to go here, KCU leads 41-21, and we've got a stoppage here in play as an injured knot, KCU knot, out on the field. So thoughts and definitely prayers go to him. But, Coach, three-score lead right now. How are you feeling if you're KCU?
Well, they've got all the momentum, obviously. They want to make sure that anything that St. Andrews gets to this point, that they make them drive and make them earn every yard of it. They don't want to give up anything, deep, any big, long chunk plays right now. But you just kind of still playing a long way to go, 41-21. But they're just trying to keep everything in front of them right now and make them earn it, kind of force St. Andrews into some more mistakes.
2-by-2 set as Fowler takes the ball, drops back, throws it into the flats, and it's dropped by Marquise McCoy. He's had a great game, two touchdowns, a couple other catches, but that one was definitely catchable. He just dropped it.
Yeah, a little comeback route there, and kind of tried to put it on his back shoulder, and he reached back for it and wasn't able to haul it in. That would have been had plenty of yardage there for the first down if he was able to, but. So they're going to kind of be forced to go for it here. I don't think they have any choice but to go for it from midfield. Still 45 seconds to go in the third quarter, but they are going to go for it. And if they don't get it here, it's a big decision here.
Yep. As Fowler drops back on fourth down, looking downfield under pressure. And, Coach, he's going to be sacked on fourth down.
Yeah, nowhere to go with the ball. And Jalen Muhammad able to ride him down in the backfield and end up with an 8-9 yard loss on the play, 7 or 8 yard loss on the play, and a big sack. The KCU defense rises to the occasion, and the offense is very anxious to get back out there and really put this thing out of touch.
They're already out on the field. Well, I know. Well, we got something going on here, the official. Okay, I think he was just double-checking everything to make sure. But, yeah, it's going to be first down and 10. KCU offense already out on the field, and we're ready to rock and roll here with 39.5 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Up back goes in motion from right to left, and it's going to be a handoff up the middle. The handoff goes to Gerald Daniels, who marches ahead for a pickup of four, maybe five on first down. And, Coach, you said there, KCU – they know they've got the momentum, they're upbeat, and, man, it's really noticeable.
Yeah, it's definitely blood in the water right now. They can smell it, and they want to get that second win. They're kind of coming in. I think they felt like they should win this game, and when it was a scoreless first quarter, they had a little bit of pressure on them, and is this thing going to be tight? What's going to happen? And now that they've kind of stretched it out just a little bit, they definitely, a lot of smiles on the sideline, and they feel like they can put the pressure on them here.
Ball snapped as time expires in the third quarter. A great ball downfield for Maxwell Ward, just not able to be hauled in by Keon Smith. So that incomplete pass means that after three quarters of play, your score, Kentucky Christian University 41, St. Andrews 21. Back after this for quarter number four on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
Kentucky Christian University is a private, not-profit university located in the beautiful foothills of eastern Kentucky. KCU offers both undergraduate and graduate programs, including the new Teacher Leader Master of Arts in Education degree. They also have an array of competitive sports. Kentucky Christian University is committed to focusing on Christ while helping students build character and prepare for their future careers. Visit kcu.edu to learn more or to schedule a visit on campus.
With loan rates at or near historical lows, now is the time to talk to one of the experienced loan officers at First National Bank. We can help you with that new car or home you've been wanting. Let us work with you to reach the payment level you're comfortable with. You can now access our loan application online at fnbgrayson.com or give us a call today at 606-928-0000 and we can make your loan happen. First National Bank in Canonsburg, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
At the start of the fourth quarter here, your score 41-21. And, Coach, again, here comes that momentum from KCU. They're flying out, you know, bouncing around out on the field there. And a little bit different story over there on that St. Andrews sideline.
Yeah, KCU definitely feeling it. They're trying to put the nail in the coffin here, so to speak.
Maxwell
St. Andrews on their heels.
Yes, sir. Ward takes the snap, hands it to Gerald Daniels, who's going to cut it back across field, and he's got room to run. More than enough for the first down. Gets it down inside the 25, down to the 23-yard line. A big pickup on third down.
Yeah, really nice cutback run there by Gerald.
Great vision there to see that lane.
Really nice. Yeah, absolutely. Really nice run. Gerald, not the tallest guy in the world. He gets in there. He's kind of hard to find.
Sure.
But he's a very strong runner, very powerful runner, and did a nice job of, like you said, seeing the cutback and hitting it, picking up big yards.
Ward with a running back behind him. That is
– oh!
Oh, Coach. Almost a dangerous play there.
Yeah, really immediately someone came through immediately, and just as big number 45, I think Brandon Carter, just as he got the ball, he was contacted there, and I missed the number of the St. Andrews defender that came free, but he caused a fumble, and then one of the KCU offensive linemen was able to jump back on that thing, and could have been a turnover there real quick for the Knights, but kind of heads up by one of the offensive linemen there to get back on it. And I'm not sure who blew the assignment, not sure exactly who that was that came through there, but one of the St. Andrews defenders was really in the backfield almost immediately. And as you said, Carter was in the pistol formation. So as he came through, as he came, you know, the two or three steps to get the ball, the defender from St. Andrews was right there on the mesh point.
Manasseh Reipert, the down KCU Knight, he's up and making his way off the field on his own accord. So that's a good thing.
I think it might have been big Mr. Rippert right there that got on the ball for the Knights. I think he might have been the one that also recovered
right.
That fumble, which was a big deal.
Big heads-up play for sure. So second down and 15 yards to go after the loss of five on the fumble. And here we go, two receivers to the left, and it's going to be a fake handoff on Jett after a receiver motion. And it looks like Ward's going to keep it himself. He gets enough for the first down inside the 10-yard line, but I do see a flag back here in the backfield, Coach, and that's usually an indication of a hold or a blocking the back, something like that.
We're going to get one of the offensive linemen there for KCU on a holding as Maxwell scrambled out to his left. And a lot of times when those linemen are engaged and that quarterback scrambles and that D lineman starts to take off, starts to go for the quarterback that's kind of leaving, as he tries to disengage, it's just kind of natural to reach out and grab him. And that's what happened there. And I didn't get the number of the kid there, but I did see the holding. Unfortunately, that's going to bring back a long run from Maxwell. Could have had it down inside the 10-yard line there, but instead going to bring up a second and very long situation.
Yeah, we go from second and long to second and really long. Be second down and
– that math degree coming in handy.
Yeah. That's about as far as I can get you. Really long. Anyway – I'm not even going to try. I'm waiting on to put it on the scoreboard. Second and 23. So here we go. Ward takes it. He's going to hand it off to Terrence Carter. Tries to find some room outside to the left. Nothing there. And I think he's maybe a yard or two. But
yeah. Austin Hunt, again, there's Austin Hunt, another name we've called several times again today, coming up from his linebacker spot to kind of make that play. Had a little help there from – one of the defensive linemen there, Devin Turner. They kind of combined on a stop. So third and long, and really KCU in a situation here where they don't have to do anything silly.
Right.
You know, would be nice to pick up maybe 10 to 12 yards, would not give them a first down, but might put them in Paul Rodriguez field goal range. So, you know, we'll see if they go for something underneath here maybe.
The snap goes to Ward with 1 second on the play clock. He finds a receiver, almost loses balance, shakes off one would-be tackler, and Coach gets it across the 20, and that's a first down KCU.
I think he's going to be short of the first down, Coach.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's Devontae again, a guy that, like I said, we've seen him in the backfield as a running back. We've also seen him lined up as a wide receiver, and he makes a nice run and catch there. But we do have another flag on the play. Way back behind the play.
The big post here that's impeding my line of vision.
Yeah.
I had to lean to the other side, and I thought he was crossing the 20 there, not the 25. But the flag, it is an indication that the flag was on KCU. Did you see what he called there?
Yeah, we got another holding call. So consecutive plays of holding here on the KCU offensive line. And, again, apologize for not knowing the number of the individual, but they don't have the official mic'd up, so it's very difficult to know who they might have caught down in there. And nevertheless, it doesn't really matter. It's just consecutive holding plays. And so after a nice gain there that would have put us in field goal range,
sure.
Really nice run and catch from Devontae. It's going to back him up again. And now they got Devontae lined up in the backfield. The guy can do a little bit of everything.
Yeah. Maxwell Ward takes the snap, throws it out of the backfield to Devontae, crosses the 40 down to the 30, still on his feet, down to the 25. So a big gain, but not near enough for a first down.
Yeah. And so we'll see whether that's in Paul Rodriguez field goal range. And it looks like they're going to give him a shot.
I think you're right. I see Paul on the field. Ball is on the 26-yard line, so that'll make it a 36-yard field goal.
That's we got 36-yard field goal. And he's got a long of 41 this year, so it is in his range.
The snap, the kick's up.
I think he's got it.
It's
nope.
Going to be wide left.
But we
Coach.
Do have a flag
That's
on the
right.
play, and it might be that St. Andrews was in the neutral zone.
Offsides on the defense, Coach.
Yeah.
So that'll bump it up 5 more yards. We're at 4th and 14 right now. That'll make it 4th and 9. I do see Rodriguez and the kick, the field goal unit still out there
on
the field.
Yeah, he had the leg there. He had the distance. Yeah, it was just off the left. So that's going to put the ball on the 22-yard line.
Yep.
So they'll spot the kick is going to happen from the 29-yard line. So we got a 39-yard field goal attempt here.
The kick's up.
Nope.
Somebody got a hand on that one.
It looked like somebody kind of got their hand up there right at the line of scrimmage and was able to deflect that ball out to the left and never really had a chance of going through there. So
11:34 to go here in this ball game. KCU with a commanding lead, 41-21 in this AAC conference game and the Battle of the Knights. Between KCU and St. Andrews, 41-21.
Yeah, so disappointing we weren't able to get some points on the board there, but the defense needs to go back out here and get another stop.
I wish we knew how many KCU drives have not resulted in points today.
Yeah.
Not many.
Nope.
It's going to be St. Andrews football. And it's almost – it's knocked away anyway on the screen.
Yeah, they're trying to throw a little flare out there to Williams. All right, to Mark – who was that? Oh, that was Leggett. Sorry,
Leggett.
Excuse me. Yeah, they're trying to throw a little flare out there to Leggett, but it was covered pretty good. And so Fowler just throws the ball away and second down and 10. KCU has kind of forced St. Andrews kind of into a situation here where they've just about got to throw the ball on nearly every play now to kind of get themselves back in it if they can.
Fowler takes it. He finds a receiver over in the flats. That is Marquise McCoy, one of his favorite targets. and he's got enough for a first down.
Yeah, I'd like to know Marquise's receiving stats for today. He's gotten several catches, has a bunch of yards, and he's a matchup problem. We talked about him being 6'4", maybe as you said, 6'5", and so he does a good job of kind of finding some open ground in there, and they really can't wait too long. You know, KCU's kind of got some soft coverage and see if they're just patient enough to keep kind of taking those underneath throws.
Fowler's going to take it himself off tackle left side. Gets about 10 yards. It's going to be close to a first down, I think, depending on the spot. Yeah, they're moving the chains. First down, St. Andrews, the quarterback Fowler there. He we know he's got the ability, and he showed it there.
Yeah, he is not a what I would call fleet of foot, but, boy, when he decides to go, he pulls that thing down.
That's
and
right.
Takes off with it, and he is not dodging anybody. You know, he runs a lot like a strong tailback or maybe even a fullback to some degree. He's carrying guys and fighting for every yard he can get.
Clock still rolling under 11 minutes to go in the ball game, and St. Andrews on the move. Fowler takes the snap. He's hit as he throws a wobbly ball, and it's going to be intercepted downfield, and off to the races is – the defender who made that catch, I believe, is that Shellman, Tamichael Shellman?
Yep.
That is Tamichael Shellman. And a huge play there for KCU. Gives him the football back.
Yeah,
another turnover.
Give Justin Lewis an assist right there.
Yeah.
That's where the pressure was coming from. And just as Fowler let the ball go, Lewis able to make contact with him and certainly affected that throw. And Shellman gets credit for the interception, but he should go over and give big Justin Lewis a pat on the head.
I agree.
For kind of setting up that opportunity for him.
So the KCU offense will take over here with 10 minutes, 40 seconds left to go in a 41-21 lead. And you can hear, I'm sure you can hear through our microphones, the KCU sideline a little bit animated down there.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah, they're very excited.
Yeah.
They're very happy with themselves down there, and they've done a great job today and several takeaways and really making life tough on Mr. Fowler.
Max Ward takes the ball, hands it off up the middle. Josh Traylor, the up back, takes it and marches ahead for a decent gain on first down. Casey, you've been pretty efficient on first down, I feel like, today, Coach.
Yeah, they have. They've done a good job of kind of keeping themselves in manageable down distance. They haven't been behind the chains very much today, and that's been one of the big keys to their success.
Yep. Second down and we'll say second down of 4 yards to go, four or five anyway. As Max Ward, the quarterback, in the gun, three receivers to his left. He hands it off again. Again, it goes to Traylor. Runs to the right side for a positive gain of three, maybe four. And we've got a flag as he's pushed out of bounds. We've got a flag over on the KCU sideline.
Yeah. I think that's Mr. Rippert again. He was down a little bit earlier in the game, but he was just kind of finishing a block there on the boundary and gave one of the St. Andrews players a little extra shove and knocked him over into the bench area. And it was a little bit after the play.
Yeah.
It was on the white there, out of bounds. And so they're going to push the offense back 15, as that's going to be a late hit.
Yep, I don't think there's any question about that one. That's probably a good call. Now, Mr. Rippert, I don't know that he agreed.
No.
But, yeah.
No.
That's going to be second down in
actually, it's going to be first. That's a dead ball penalty.
That's
so
right.
They had enough yardage for the first down. So they'll
That's
back
right.
them up, but it will be a first and 10 and not a first and 15 or first and 25. It'll just be a first and 10 situation.
They're still – getting the logistics worked out here. I think KCU is going to be set up at about their own 47-yard line after the 15-yard penalty. Yeah, it'll be first and 10. And the clock is rolling. Under 10 minutes to go here in this ball game. KCU leads 41-21. Three receivers to the left side of the field for Maxwell Ward. The ball's on the right hash. He's going to take the snap. He's under pressure, steps up in the pocket. He's going to have to sprint out to his left, and he's going to throw it away. Throws it over toward that St. Andrews sideline. That'll bring up a second down.
Yeah, initial pressure there from Monte Williams off the off the offensive left side, kind of flushes him out of the pocket. And then you got Austin Hunt at same inside linebacker, kind of running him down and forcing the throw. However, they're going to get him for intentional grounding outside the pocket. But part of that rule is that ball's got to go beyond the line of scrimmage.
That's
and
right.
I think Maxwell forgot about that part of it as he was several yards. He was about 10 yards behind the line as he let that thing go, and it did not make it back to the line of scrimmage.
It was well behind the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, it was a no-doubter.
Yeah.
So the pressure there from Monte Williams and Austin Hunt kind of forced that intentional grounding. So big loss of yard and loss of down. It's going to make it second and 21.
And that's one of those things that as a young player, young quarterback, I bet he doesn't make that mistake again.
That's right, yeah. Yep. He'll remember that next time. And he just kind of casually flicked that thing out of bounds but forgot to get it past the line of scrimmage.
And that's a completion there, Coach, to number 86, Dimitri Bose. And he's off to the races, Coach. Gets it down inside the 15-yard line before he goes out of bounds. The junior wide receiver listed at 6'3", 188 pounds, and a big-time catch there for him. I believe his first one of the game.
Yeah, it's good to see it. Again, we talked about at halftime how Maxwell's spreading that ball around, a lot of different people getting involved in there. So there's Bose with a big catch. And, again, another one of those quick slants that those receivers, those explosive wide receivers, are able to take down the field for a big game.
First down and 10 yards to go here from the St. Andrews 13-yard line, I should say. Almost said their own 13-yard line. Here we go. Ward takes the snap, looks into the end zone, lofts one up there just off the fingertips of Devontae Williams. He was trying to lead him into that back corner of the end zone.
They leak him out of the backfield. Devontae lines up as the single back. He goes out to the flat and then turns that thing up the boundary right there. A little wheel route out of the backfield and tried to lead him down there. But pretty well covered by St. Andrews. And so you see Tyler Haas trot onto the field now. We've seen him inside the red zone. We've seen him inside the 5-yard line twice now. I think this might be the first time we've seen him outside of the 10. So be interesting to see here whether they let Tyler throw one or not.
Ward takes it. He's going to hand it off to a receiver on a jet play there. That is K'Ron Taylor, who marches it ahead. It gets it inside around the 10-yard line, we'll say, so about a 3-yard pickup, Coach.
Yeah.
And they fought for about that last yard. He's not a bigger body guy, but he's not an easy guy to bring down.
No, he's a hard runner, kind of a small frame guy, but he's very quick, very shifty. It's good to get the ball in his hands. He hasn't had a lot of catches today. But you got a kid explosive like that, you want to get it in his hands a number of different ways. And so Tyler's still going to stay in the game here at quarterback. And, again, Devontae lines up to his left. Been thinking quarterback run when Tyler's in the game, but he can throw the balls. He started several games of quarterback earlier this year, and they'll let him throw it right here.
Absolutely. He's forced to kind of sprint out, though, cuts it back, looks into the end zone, throws it, and throws it in some traffic there, hit as he threw, and that one's going to go incomplete. And I'm trying to see who is intended. That's Taylen Rucker Daly. He got under pressure there, kind of felt that pressure, sprinted out, came back, set up, threw it almost a little bit.
Yeah,
I think the pressure might have got to him.
Yeah, absolutely. Kind of tough to describe there. He wanted to stay in the pocket. He really didn't want to take off and run right there, so he tried to just kind of move around in the pocket and avoid some pressure and just underthrown here a little bit. And so we'll see Paul Rodriguez come on for his second field goal attempt of the day.
Yes, sir. This one from 20 yards out. It's up, and it's good. So a 20-yard field goal makes it 44-21 here, Coach. And I'm looking at the KCU schedule, 44.
We might have a roughing situation right here.
We'll see
whether they want to take the points off the board or they get running into or roughing the kicker. We'll probably determine that. If it's roughing the kicker, I'd say they'll probably decline it. And that's what it is.
Yes, sir. The penalties declined. So a 44-21 is the score. And I was just going to say, I was looking at the schedule, 44 points. Most points KCU scored this year.
Oh,
that's their season high.
Yeah.
So
very good.
Moving in the right direction.
Absolutely.
44-21, KCU leads St. Andrews. Back after this on the Cool Hits Sports Network.
In addition to the Greenup location, Stelz Pharmacy's newest location is at 437 James Hanna Drive in South Shore, but has retained the name you know and love, McDonald Pharmacy, with the same great service you'll find in the Greenup location, with free delivery service and their convenient drive-through. Get your vaccinations and allergy shots, and of course, great prescription service. At Stelz Pharmacy in Greenup and McDonald Pharmacy, James Hanna Drive, South Shore.
Stelz Pharmacy.
When you have business away from home or a planned event far from your comfort zone, you're probably going to need a little help. Let A&A Porta Potties assist you with all your portable toilet needs. Whether on a construction site, planning for an outdoor wedding, or any other outdoor event, A&A Porta Potties are here to assist you. A&A Porta Potties also rents out storage containers, office containers, cooling fans, tables, and chairs. A&A Porta Potties, there is no event too big or too small for us to accommodate you.
And we're back here in Grayson, and a big kickoff return in progress. If you're watching on Cool TV, getting it all the way back to almost midfield is who is that number 88, Coach, I think? Keon Smith, I do believe. But a huge kickoff return nonetheless for St. Andrews.
Yep, and your boy right there, Paul Rodriguez, knocks him out of bounds with pretty good shot. They're all giving him a lot of – dapping him up over there on the sideline for the big hit, kind of knocked him out of bounds. He didn't just go kicker right there and push him.
That's right.
He kind of laid the pads on him right there. And if you're not watching on Cool TV, you know that that Paul's not a small dude. And he's got a little power there.
Not a tall dude.
That's right. But not a small dude.
Yes.
And able to knock him out of bounds with a little force right there.
You know, a lot of times when you say your boy, it's kind of poking fun at somebody. Yeah. I'll take Paul Rodriguez any day of the week.
Absolutely.
And I mean that.
I know you do. I know.
Yep. A handoff up the middle. It's going to go this time to a new up back. That is Antarius Carpenter.
Carry by number 40.
And a decent game, decent gain, I should say, a 7-yard gain on first down. Antarius Carpenter. I think that was his freshman running back. He's listed 180 pounds. That was his first carry of the ball game.
Yeah, it just looks like they're just trying to get some guys in there, some new look guys in there.
And sure.
You know, 44-21, 7 minutes to go. Not that they're giving up or anything like that, but, you know, good to get these guys a look in under game conditions.
That's right. That's right. Another handoff goes to Carpenter, this time right side. And he's going to pick up a couple yards, maybe 3 yards, but not quite enough for the first down. It'll be third down and around 1 yard to go here.
For the
Knights of St. Andrews.
From the JCU 43-yard line.
Six minutes, 45 seconds to go. And the clock's still rolling here in Grayson. A big win, a big lead. I don't mean a big win. I mean a big lead for KCU. And this time a host of KCU Knights brings down Antarius Carpenter as he tries to run it outside. That'll be a loss, and it's going to bring up fourth down.
Yeah, not able to really to get much going there on the from Carpenter. D-line kind of all over that one. Host of Knights kind of there combining on that stop, kind of push them back. So, again, St. Andrews in a situation here where they're kind of forced to go for it.
So on fourth down and 3 yards to go, Fowler's going to take the snap and drop back to pass. He tries to get it to one of his favorite targets, Marquise McCoy, down the sideline, but they're unable to connect, and that should mean it's going to be KCU's football.
Yeah, I think Fowler thought he had a free play. There was a little movement up there by the KCU defense.
That would make sense. Yeah,
but the officials, I think, thought, and that's what Fowler is pleading his case out there right now. But I think the official is going to say that KCU got back. You know, in college football, you know, you can get into the neutral zone, but you can get out. It's not an automatic infraction.
It's all about when the ball snapped.
It's all about when the ball snapped in college football as compared to high school. And so they must have said that they got back. And I think Fowler thought for sure that KCU was in the neutral zone at the snap. And so he just hauled off and threw it down the right boundary there, really didn't have much of a chance. And so, but there was no flag, and so no penalty. And so first down Knights.
Here we go, handoff on first down. This time it's going to go. He's off to the races, Coach. That's Josh Traylor down the sideline inside the 10-5 touchdown, KCU.
Yeah,
a 55-yard touchdown for – KCU, that's Josh Traylor. Wow. Yeah,
really quick strike there for the KCU offense. I think kind of caught St. Andrews off guard there a little bit. He takes it down the left side for a pretty much untouched touchdown there.
Yeah.
Got a guy, a receiver, one of the receivers out blocking there on the perimeter. I think that's number 88, Keon Smith, if I'm not mistaken. I don't want to give that maybe too early, but it looked like it might have been Keon over there blocking a little bit. I'm not sure exactly what happened, but that touchdown kind of came down behind where he was blocking, and so not sure what happened to him.
Thoughts and prayers go to him as the training staff of Kentucky Christian University over there attending to him, Coach. But 50 points on the scoreboard, that's a big deal.
Yeah, absolutely. That's really good to see. And, you know, really in three quarters they've been able to do that as they kind of got started off a little bit slow in the first quarter, but really have poured it on since then.
Yeah.
And you just felt like, honestly, you felt like every time KCU got the ball, if they didn't stop themselves, if they didn't turn it over, they were going to score.
Sure, sure.
And, I'm not sure, has KCU punted today? I don't recall a single punt today.
I don't think so.
When you never have to trot your punter out on the field, it's a heck of a day.
That is Keon Smith as he makes his way back off the field with some assistance. Coach Russell out there and one of the assistant coaches out there helping Keon off the field. So, prayers for that young man, whatever is going on there.
Yeah, you hope Keon's all right. He's been a big contributor, and he will continue to be he's a guy they're going to need down the stretch here as we get into November and the last few games of the season. You'd like to be able to see him as he's really starting to – offense is starting to play, and Keon's one of the main contributors.
That's right. No doubt about it, Coach. 5:45 to go in this ball game. KCU leads it 50-21. And we've got Mr. Paul Rodriguez out there now looking to tack one more on, make it a 30-point lead for KCU. Field goal unit out. And here we go. The snap and the kick. That one is good. So that makes it 51-21 with 5:45 to go in the ball game. Back after this, live here from Grayson on the Cool Hits Sports Network.
In addition to the Greenup location, Stelz Pharmacy's newest location is at 437 James Hanna Drive in South Shore, but has retained the name you know and love, McDonald Pharmacy. With the same great service you'll find in the Greenup location, with free delivery service and their convenient drive-through. Get your vaccinations and allergy shots, and of course, great prescription service. At Stelz Pharmacy in Greenup and McDonald Pharmacy, James Hanna Drive, South Shore.
Stelz Pharmacy.
When you have business away from home or a planned event far from your comfort zone, you're probably going to need a little help. Let A&A Porta Potties assist you with all your portable toilet needs. Whether on a construction site, planning for an outdoor wedding, or any other outdoor event, A&A Porta Potties are here to assist you. A&A Porta Potties also rents out storage containers, office containers, cooling fans, tables, and chairs. A&A Porta Potties, there is no event too big or too small for us to accommodate you.
And we're back here in Grayson. KCU with a 30-point lead, 51-21, with under 6 minutes to go here in the ball game. And, Coach, what a play there. One play of offense, 55 yards and a touchdown from Josh Traylor.
Yeah, I think they kind of caught St. Andrews really off guard there. Just, you know, a lot of big momentum switch there. There was the controversy of whether it was a free play or not from the fourth down. So they turn it over, and St. Andrews a little bit let down. Not much emotion going on over there. So they hand it off, and off to the races. They go for a long score.
This time the pooch kick is caught by Devontae Allen, who's going to cross all the way across the field to the numbers over toward the St. Andrews sideline. The kick was toward the KCU sideline, and he caught it right about the 25-yard line, and he's going to bring it out somewhere around the 35, something like that. We'll find out exactly where, but around a 10-yard kickoff return there. He ran about 50 to get about 10, something like that, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I'd say so.
Yeah. 36-yard line's where they're going to set up, First and 10 for St. Andrews offensively with 5:36 to go here in the ball game.
Fowler remains quarterback for St. Andrews.
Yes, sir. He's going to hand it off to who is that, Coach?
Carpenter.
That's Carpenter again, isn't it? Yeah.
Yep. Young running back there. They mostly went with Leggett and Allen today, but Carpenter on the last two series, his freshman, has been in the game, just trying to get some reps in there as we kind of end this thing, wind this thing down. 5:15 on a running clock. You know, really impressive showing from the KCU offense today, I feel like.
I agree.
Hanging 51 on the board after a scoreless first quarter.
Yes.
Several explosive chunk plays. Receivers have played well.
Another handoff goes to Carpenter and a big gain on second down. He made a couple moves there, planted his foot a time or two, and bent it back toward the sideline. And a big gain there about, well, 21 yards, I think, Coach, something like that.
Yeah, nice 21-yard run there from Carpenter. So he'll get a little break, and they bring another tailback into the game. And that's going to be number 37, Eldrick Williams, a name that we haven't seen too much of today, but he'll line up at the tailback position.
And he does take the handoff, gets it almost back to the line of scrimmage, and he's gobbled up by a host of KCU Knights. And that reminds me, I was thinking a minute ago when we said a host of Knights. You know how there's like a pride of Lions?
Mm-hmm.
Or, well, what is a group of Knights called?
Got me.
I don't know either.
I don't know if that has a name or not.
Yeah. Anyway, that's how my mind works, Coach. Second down, 10 yards to go here. Clock running under 4. Well, we're down to about 4:07 here. And here we go. Second down. He's going to drop back to pass, and he's going to find a receiver right in the middle of the field for a positive gain there. That is number 87, Justin Lewis, a freshman wide receiver, who made the catch there.
Time out on the field.
Yep.
And that is not Justin Lewis. That's Dante Crowder.
Yeah.
My fault.
Nice little route over the middle there. I'm going to catch a flag here, a late flag, unsportsmanlike.
Dead ball, unsportsmanlike on KCU.
So that'll tack another 15 onto Crowder's catch.
Yeah, that'll bring it almost to the red zone, down to the 21-yard line.
Yep. KCU just trying to keep everything in front of them, basically trying to make them earn, try to keep them, from throwing anything over the top right now. Pretty soft.
That's
coverage
right
out there on the corners, trying to make them throw the ball underneath, try to just contain the run.
We got a clock issue here. There's 3:50 on the clock, but the referee said put 3:55 on the clock, so they want 5 more seconds added to the game clock. And we're waiting on that to happen. That explains the delay in the game here, mm-hmm. or the delay in play anyway. And there we go. Got it fixed on the scoreboard.
That's important 5 seconds. I'm glad they fixed that.
Yeah. Now the clock's running again. Oh, my goodness. Fowler takes the snap. Going to fake a handoff and drop back again. He's under pressure. He's going to sprint out toward his sideline. And his throw downfield is knocked away. Somebody got a hand on it there. Who is that, Coach? Can you tell the number?
I cannot tell the number, but I was looking at that.
Derek Houston.
Derek Houston, yeah. Uh-huh. So the guy I was going to call out there is Trent Hill. Again, I think Fowler is going to have nightmares. He's going to wake up in the night screaming about 97, chasing him all over the field. He has gotten several good hits on him, and he has flushed him out of the pocket a number of times. That young man is going to sleep well tonight.
Yeah.
Trent Hill has just continually applied pressure to Fowler.
What do we have going on here, Coach?
Penalty flag on the play.
Okay, too many players on the field.
Yeah.
So 12 men on the field for St. Andrews. That'll back him up 5 yards. and make it second down at 15 yards. 3:41 to go in the ball game. And the official, they're pretty adamant about get that clock running.
Yeah.
They wanted that 5 seconds on it, but make sure you run it. Fowler hands it off. This time it's going to go again to Eldrick Williams, who tries to get off tackle left side and does just that. Picks up about, they got their 5 yards back, so that makes it third and 10.
Yep.
Down to 3:15 on the clock. KCU, by all intents and purposes, coming out of here with a big win like this, that's a big deal.
Yeah, it's a step forward, a game that I do believe that they lost last year. So, it takes a step forward to get the win this year and, hopefully take another step toward, maybe picking up another win down this year. They've still got Bluefield left, which is a game that they can certainly win. So, I think they got a lot to be happy about, and that'll make for a spirited week of practice.
That's right. The clock will stop there on that incomplete pass on third down. Fowler dropped back. He was under pressure and ran out of the pocket, just threw it out of bounds. Nobody opened downfield.
Yeah, so been impressed with all the people that have contributed to this win. It's really been a team win.
There's a lot of names you can say.
Yeah, absolutely. A lot of guys that have contributed to this game. It's not just been Maxwell Ward, kind of putting the team on his back. He's had a lot of help from a lot of different receivers. The defense has played a lot of guys. They've rotated a lot of defensive linemen. They've continuously got some pressure. They've been good in the back end. It's just been a good team win.
Fowler's going to keep it himself, run it down inside the 10-yard line. He's brought down right around the 10, we'll say. And that'll be enough for a first down. It'll be first and goal, I think, from the 10. And clock's still rolling. Down under 3 minutes. We're at 2:39 now. And still running.
That was Cameron Arthur coming out of the secondary there to kind of clean Fowler up a little bit there before he could get to the 10-yard line or right at the 10-yard line.
Ball's going to be on the left hash. Fowler with Carpenter offset to his left. He's going to drop back. No, he's going to hand it off to Carpenter, and Carpenter's going to bring it down, I believe, around the 6-yard line. We got a flag there. We got several players in on that tackle from both sides, I guess. O-line was in there. Carpenter was in there, and then several defenders, and the flag thrown after the tackle. See what we've got here.
I think we're going to get one of the offensive linemen from St. Andrews maybe with a unsportsmanlike penalty here. Huh?
I don't know. The officials are in the middle there, still kind of huddled up talking about they've sort of dispersed now, but still no signal yet from the head official as to what we got. Here we go.
Yep, there it is.
I think you called that one, didn't you?
Yeah.
Unsportsmanlike conduct penalty on St. Andrews.
I didn't have the second one.
No, you did not.
No. They're going to offset there. They're going to get KCU off, so.
That's one of those things. Some of them you can see, but some of them you can't see. Nobody can see. It's something you hear or say or something like that.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
You
so you don't know about
happened.
Those.
That's
yeah.
right. You never
yeah.
know what happens down in there.
That's right.
I certainly saw the kid from St. Andrews there with the late hit. And then something happened after that, I suppose.
Yep, I think you're right. So it's going to be second down and goal from the 7 as Fowler sprints out to his right and finds a receiver in the end zone. That's number 80, Todrick Walker. Sorry, that's a tongue twister for me. Todrick Walker. I messed up on his name earlier, and I apologize about that.
Yeah, a little boot action there. They fake the inside handoff, sprint out to the right, and he finds the big tight end there, Walker, in the end zone, a little flat route just beyond the goal line. Nice little throw and catch. And they'll trot the extra point team out there to try to make it 28-51.
With a minute 55 seconds left to go in this ball game, that makes your score 51-27. I think you just said that. But here comes McFadder on, and the kick's up. And it's good. So the PAT makes it 51-28. KCU still leads with a minute 55 to go. But back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
In addition to the Greenup location, Stelz Pharmacy's newest location is at 437 James Hanna Drive in South Shore, but has retained the name you know and love, McDonald Pharmacy, with the same great service you'll find in the Greenup location, with free delivery service and their convenient drive-thru. Get your vaccinations and allergy shots, and of course, great prescription service. At Stelz Pharmacy in Greenup and McDonald Pharmacy, James Hanna Drive, South Shore.
Stelz Pharmacy.
When you have business away from home or a planned event far from your comfort zone, you're probably going to need a little help. Let A&A Porta Potties assist you with all your portable toilet needs. Whether on a construction site, planning for an outdoor wedding, or any other outdoor event, A&A Porta Potties are here to assist you. A&A Porta Potties also rents out storage containers, office containers, cooling fans, tables, and chairs. A&A Porta Potties, there is no event too big or too small for us to accommodate you.
Back in Grayson, Kentucky, minute 55 seconds left on the clock, 51-28. Kentucky Christian University leads St. Andrews in the Battle of the Knights here, Coach. The traveling trophy is up for grabs. Here we go. Kicks in the air and attempted onside
pick
kick.
It up.
Uh-oh. And it's down there at the St. Andrews 41 or 36-yard line, excuse me. They were trying for the onside kick, I think. And
it's the shortest kickoff I've ever seen.
Yeah. It almost went backwards.
Yes, he tried to onside kick, tried to get a little short roll there in the middle of the – and he just touched the ball and it just barely fell off the tee. He darn near missed it, and the ball traveled a whopping – half a yard.
Maybe.
And then it just laid out there.
Yeah.
And one of the
they seem to forget there.
Yeah, one of the St. Andrews kids finally had to go pick it up and to kill it like a punt. So we kick off at the 35, and the Knights have the ball at the 36.
They for a few seconds there, they seem to forget that's a live football.
Yeah. I was waiting for maybe one of Casey's kids just to go scoop it up
and score, baby. Yeah.
Yeah. But that is I've been around for a long time. I don't think I've ever seen a shorter kickoff in my life.
Yeah. So after the kickoff, KCU takes over first and 10 on the St. Andrews 36. A handoff's going to go to the left side, and gaining a couple yards is – well, I can't tell you who that is yet. I can now. That's 45. That would be Terrence Carter, who picks up a couple, maybe 3 yards on first down. And, Coach, KCU here, let that clock roll.
Yeah, it looks like Maxwell Ward's day is done. They've taken him out of the game. Tyler Hall is in at quarterback.
I think I said that was Ward, didn't I?
Yeah. And he's going to take the last few snaps. But KCU being very patient, trying to use all the play clock here.
That's right.
St. Andrews not using their timeouts. And maybe one or two more snaps left here.
Hand off again is going to go up the middle to Carter. He's going to march ahead for another decent pickup on second down. Picked up another maybe 5 yards. That'll make it maybe 6 yards. That'll make it – no, how about 7 yards?
Yep.
That referee kept moving forward.
Yep.
So he goes from the 33 down to the 24-yard line, I believe, something like, or 26-yard line, sorry. Be first and 10 from the 26. As Haas directing a little traffic here. Got one receiver out wide each way and a slot receiver to the left as well. This time the handoff is going to go to number 41. And, Coach, we don't have a 41 on our roster.
Yeah, not sure who that young man is, but he'll pick up a collegiate carry.
There you go.
And
we're down under 15 now to 10 seconds.
I don't think that they'll have to snap the ball anymore here if they don't want to.
I think you're right. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and as clock expires here, Coach.
Yep.
That's a big game for the Kentucky Christian University Knights.
Well,
51-28 win over a conference opponent. And Coach Russell gets the ice water bath, probably Gatorade, I don't know. But he's wet and cold. Congratulations to KCU on a big, big victory.
Yeah, that's a good win, a nice team win. A lot of people contributing. There'll be a lot to be happy about. That'll be a fun film session come tomorrow evening when they get together and and start to go back to work. They'll kind of get themselves together. I'm sure there's always going to be some corrections to be made, but they'll start getting ready for Point as they have another conference game next Saturday at noon. This one will be at Point. And so they'll get ready and they'll take a look at them. But a lot to be happy about.
Absolutely.
A lot of contributors, and I'm sure they're very excited and they'll enjoy this one tonight.
Yep, no doubt about it. Coach, we're going to step out, take a break. Again, your final score of the evening, Kentucky Christian University 51 and St. Andrews 28. Back after this for the postgame show, and we'll have a word from Coach Jake Russell, so don't go away. We'll be back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
You know, financial security begins at home, with home ownership. If you've been putting off looking for a home because you think you can't afford it, you owe it to yourself to check out Members Choice Credit Union. Members Choice Credit Union has programs for first-time homebuyers and more to help put you in the home of your dreams. Call, click, or stop by Members Choice Credit Union today.
Members Choice Credit Union, NMLS 411-945, Equal Housing Lender. Call for additional information. Other restrictions may apply.
In addition to the Greenup location, Stelz Pharmacy's newest location is at 437 James Hanna Drive in South Shore, but has retained the name you know and love, McDonald Pharmacy, with the same great service you'll find in the Greenup location, with free delivery service and a convenient drive-through. Get your vaccinations and allergy shots, and of course, great prescription service. At Stultz Pharmacy in Greenup and McDonald Pharmacy, James Hanna Drive, South Shore.
Stultz Pharmacy.
Uncle Rick, what are you doing?
I'm trying to stay cooler in my man cave.
Well, this is a beer cave, and you can't stay in this cooler forever.
But Clark's Pub and Shop can get you through the dog days of summer.
Whether it's fountain drinks at the lowest price or you're filling up the cooler for the family and friends, Clark's has the widest selection, the best prices, and the most helpful staff you'll find anywhere.
Beat the heat at Clark's Pub and Shop.
Return, refresh, refuel.
When you want real, authentic Mexican menu items, you want Tres Hermanos Nunez. Accept no substitutes. None compares. Fajitas, tacos, burritos, quesadillas, chimichangas, even vegetarian choices. A kid's menu, desserts, and salads, a tasty, budget-pleasing selection for you and your family, unlike any others, should be your first and only choice for authentic Mexican all throughout the tri-state. Ashland, Greenup, Grayson, Paintsville, Canova, South Point, Olive Hill, and Cannonsburg. Tres Hermanos Nunez, the best around.
And we're back in Grayson postgame show. Chauncey Griffith, Brent Terry, glad to have you along. 51-28, your final score of the evening. And while Coach, while you look over those stats, I'll tell the listeners how we got to where we are with the scoring summary. First touchdown didn't come until quarter number two. It was a Kentucky Christian University touchdown. They were on the scoreboard first. Max Ward to Devontae Williams with a huge 79-yard touchdown with 12:39 to go on the clock in the second quarter, followed by Paul Rodriguez PAT that made it 7-0. Then again in the second with 8:07 on the clock, St. Andrews with an answer, an 11-yard touchdown pass from Andrew Fowler to Marquise McCoy, followed by a Cameron McFadder PAT tied the game at 7. Again in the second quarter, KCU with an answer. 5:11 on the clock, Tyler Haas, in at quarterback, he ran it in from 4 yards out, and Paul Rodriguez tacked on another point, making it 14-7. St. Andrews, again, with an answer, they're going to tie it up here with 4:09 to go before the half. Andrew Fowler to Aronson Cook from 49 yards out, and a McFadder PAT made it 14-14. With 4:09 on the clock. Another touchdown, though, before the half. This one, a KCU touchdown from Max Ward to Taylin Rucker-Daly from 20 yards out, followed by Paul Rodriguez PAT. That made it 21-14 at the half. The third quarter was a big third quarter on the scoreboard, especially for KCU with 9:14 on the clock. In that quarter, KCU scored. Max Ward ran it in himself from about 12 yards out, and then the failed two-point conversion made it 20, 7-14. St. Andrews, again, with an answer here. They're going to bring it back within a score. 32-yard touchdown pass from Fowler to Marquise McCoy, followed by a McFadder PAT, made it 27-21. The rest of the scores until late were all KCU. Another one in the third quarter with 6:01 on the clock. A big-time interception return for around 80 yards from C.J. Cutliffe, and a Paul Rodriguez PAT made it 34-21. And then KCU got the ball again and scored with 2:53 to go in the third quarter. Tyler Haas ran it in himself from 3 yards out, and a Paul Rodriguez PAT made it 41-21. And that was the score at the end of three quarters. Then in the fourth quarter, KCU with a 27-yard field goal from Paul Rodriguez. That made it 44-21. And then with 5:45 on the clock, when they took over on offense, the first play of offense handed off to Josh Traylor. He ran it in from 55 yards out. And the PAT from Paul Rodriguez made it 51-21. And then with a minute 55 to go in the ball game, St. Andrews able to add 7 more points onto the board. From 7 yards out, Todrick Walker catches a touchdown pass from Fowler. And then a McFadder PAT made it 51-28. And that was the final score of this ball game. Coach Russell still has his team over in the end zone having his conversation with them. So, Coach, while we've got a second, do you want to go ahead and actually, I tell you what, we're going to step out, take a break, because I think I see Coach coming this way, and when he gets up here, we will we'll be ready for him, and then we'll go over stats after that. So don't go away. Back after this on the Cool Hit Sports Network.
Does your gas station or convenience store need a facelift? If so, call River City Builders at 473-4112 for your remedy. Big or small projects, River City's Builders is a company for all your needs. We have extensive experience in the petroleum industry, from routine gas dispenser and canopy maintenance to above-ground, underground tank and piping work to full-blown remodels and new builds. Call River City Builders at 473-4112 for all your petroleum needs. We'll cover your back and keep your customers pumping gas.
When you have business away from home or a planned event far from your comfort zone, you're probably going to need a little help. Let A&A Porta Potties assist you with all your portable toilet needs. Whether on a construction site, planning for an outdoor wedding, or any other outdoor event, A&A Porta Potties are here to assist you. A&A Porta Potties also rents out storage containers, office containers, cooling fans, tables, and chairs. A&A Porta Potties, there is no event too big or too small for us to accommodate you.
Jennifer Epperly, loan officer at First National Bank in Canonsburg. I personally invite you and all local businesses to visit our beautiful new building in Canonsburg on U.S. Route 60 next to the Walmart entrance. We offer many services including personal, mortgage, and business loans. First National Bank is locally owned by the McGuire family of Ashland and has been in business since 1902. We aim to give you the personal attention and best customer service there is to offer. Come inside, talk with us, and let us make you a part of the First National Bank family. First National Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Kentucky Christian University is a private, nonprofit university located in the beautiful foothills of eastern Kentucky. KCU offers both undergraduate and graduate programs, including the new Teacher Leader Master of Arts in Education degree. They also have an array of competitive sports. Kentucky Christian University is committed to focusing on Christ while helping students build character and prepare for their future careers. Visit kcu.edu to learn more or to schedule a visit on campus.
Back in Grayson, Kentucky, Chauncey Griffith, Brent Terry. We're now joined by Kentucky Christian University head football coach Jake Russell. Coach, first of all, congratulations on the big win.
Yeah, thank you. Feels good to get back on the winning side.
51-21, number one, 51 points. That's the most you guys have scored all year. Talk about offensively today, a huge day.
Yeah, most we've scored in 2 years. First 50-burger, so we're really excited about that. Defense got us 7 and then also put us in some really good spots, so that's always a big part of it. And then, you know, didn't score in the first quarter, so really about 2.5 quarters there, because, you know, the end
that's
of the
right.
game when you're up a lot kind of goes. Kind of 2.5 quarters, you know, 44 points from the offensive side. Really, really good. You know, overall great effort. They did a really good job taking away the run early. You know, we always talk about we like to establish the run and build off of that. So they did a good job kind of getting us out of our game plan, but Max played really well, pretty efficient. A couple of little mistakes there. He's still maturing and all that stuff. But and our receivers, man, that's the best game they've played overall and just did a lot with the ball in their hand. You know, we've kind of been, you know, hoping and kind of egging these guys on, you know, like, hey, we've got the talent, but it's time for you to actually go out in a game and do it and show that talent. So really proud of some of those guys today.
Yeah, that was kind of going to be my next question, Coach. You look on here, and there were 9 guys caught passes in that game. You know, that's a pretty impressive. Max did a great job kind of spreading it around. It was really a good team victory. 9 guys catch a ball. 9 different guys rush the ball during the game. Only 2 turnovers. You know, I know you were kind of talking about those guys a little bit, but I thought they did a great job after the catch. There were several. You know, spots where they kind of threw the ball, kind of find some open spots in those zones, and those guys took those balls and turned them into to long gains.
Yeah, like I said, we knew our guys had the ability to do that, and mm-hmm. a lot of that comes from, you know, things that you don't see just as the common fan where a guy catches the ball and then explodes for, you know, 40 yards. Well, it really comes into either, you know, teammates doing a great job blocking down the field or, you know, the teammates running great routes, which has created open space, open grass for those guys to run in. It's kind of, mm-hmm. you know, how football evolved. Just recently, as you know, it's now basketball on grass where you're spreading the court or spreading the field and, you know, creating that open space. And all you got to do, you know, that's what I tell Max is just, you know, it's recruiting at that point. And our guys have done a great job recruiting is get that ball in the open space and they can make plays. And our guys obviously did a really good job of doing that today.
Yeah, and the big play of the game, all that offense, 50 points on the board, 51 points on the board, all these people contributing, but the big play of the game may have been the big interception return for a touchdown. Talk about that for a minute.
Yeah, huge at that moment. I believe it was 34-21 at that point, mm-hmm. and they were down on, you know, in our territory, a fourth down there. I mean, you saw those receivers they had out there, man. Holy moly. Mm-hmm. You know, still wondering where everybody's finding all these guys, you know, 6'3", 6'5", guys. You know, and really good players, and C.J. Cutliff, just, you know, another great talent who's, man, from where he was at this point last year, really proud of him. He's had a phenomenal year. You see his talent on display when he's locked in, and, yeah, you're right, that was a huge momentum changer and really got us on that, okay, now it's a downhill battle here, take care of the ball, you know, play great defense, and we got a victory.
Yeah, the other guy kind of on defense that I thought kind of stuck out, and I, you know, it may or not have to you, but Trent Hill I felt like was all over the place. He really applied a lot of pressure, never let Fowler get comfortable back there. There were a lot of guys that really contributed on defense, but yeah. The D-line in general I thought did a nice job of putting some pressure on Fowler, making him uncomfortable.
D-line did great. I think I'm looking here, 3 sacks, which is really mm-hmm. good. A lot of tackles for loss. That's mm-hmm. a big one. Our goal was 10-plus this week, so I think we're pretty close there. But, yeah, just looking down through this defensive stats here, we've got a bunch of guys with a lot of tackles. Yeah. Trent, I mean, he's been an anchor for 2 years, you know, playing as a true freshman last year. You know, Kentucky guy who just comes in every single day, works his butt off, and has gotten better and better and better. You know, great leader within our program. And, you know, he sets the tone for those guys with his energy and his effort. And, you know, that's what Coach Owens, man, he's just like, if you just play with effort, man, I can make you something on the defensive line. He's a heck of a coach, and he's doing a great job. Because it's a young group, you know, a little bit of an inexperienced group, a couple older guys in there. But they've really gotten better throughout the season. I think that's, you know, most improved position group for sure over the course of the year. And it's really shown a difference on the defense.
Yeah. I'll throw one more at you here real quick for me, and that's it was good to see Tyler Haas come in some goal line situations, and hadn't seen all the away games, but the last time I was here I hadn't seen that package, and so maybe just talk about Tyler still contributing after starting a few games at quarterback and then, you know, but still finding a way to contribute.
He's just such a unique weapon on the offensive side and probably could play defense. We had him running down on kickoff the first game this year. I just in the bye week was thinking, you know, we got this player. We've got to figure out a way to, you know, utilize him and put him on the field. We put that package in from Reinhardt. We ran 2 plays out of it and scored one. Yeah. On one of them, joking with the guys, we're scoring about every other play. We're in that package there. Put in a couple extra offensive linemen, and then Tyler, who's, you know, first guy's never going to tackle him. He's holding mm-hmm. our kicks. He's doing a lot of things. And I'm still excited for his development as a quarterback. Mm-hmm. Trying to steal him reps in there as well. I mean, he's got the potential to be a really good quarterback as well. And, you know, he's just a great teammate too. He's the older guy in the QB room, a college graduate, just a little more mature by age than those guys. And him and Kajika Sarvis do a great job leading those young guys in there, Kajika being a senior in that group as well.
Coach, looking ahead, we don't want to keep you up here too long, man. It's a good day. Looking ahead, next week you're at Point. I had that game last year, so I kind of remember an AAC game. What can you tell us about Point?
Yeah, we beat them on the last drive here last year, so I know they've got revenge on their mind. I just told our team, I said, you know, very happy but not satisfied with today. You know, still got to find a way to start better, still got to find a way to close better. Point beat that team that we played today 48-0. So Point's a really good team this year. They've got a really good defense. Coach Zeter's new head coach there, but has been in the program a couple years as their defensive coordinator. He's done a great job on defense everywhere he's been. And, you know, away trip, it's our longest one of the year, overnighter. So, you know, there's always, you know, making sure your guys handle that really well. But, man, like we talked about on the show, you know, basically a four-game season here to end the year, and there's one. You know, there's a lot of things. You know, it's just telling our team today, and it's kind of hard to believe because they've had some really good seasons here, but KCU has never had a four-game winning streak. So that's another thing we've put, you know, in front of those guys' eyes and says, go make history. So excited for that.
Coach, congratulations.
Yep, winning's never easy. Enjoy tonight.
Absolutely.
Awesome. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you, guys.
Yes, sir. That was KCU head football coach Jake Russell and Coach Brent Terry. You got a couple stats. We'll do a quick rundown of the stats, and we'll get out of here. What do you think?
Okay, sure. You know, the most important stat is that one that's up on the scoreboard, the one they keep that everybody can see, and the Knights hang 51 on the St. Andrews Knights compared to their 28. So 51-28 victory. Kind of a couple things everybody wants to know. Total offense, you know, the St. Andrews Knight did put some yards up on KCU. They ran 86 plays for 502 offensive yards. That's pretty impressive. Our Knights counter 63 plays, 478 yards. The big one, though, you look at to me is Maxwell Ward coming through with 354 passing yards, 17 completions to get that done. Only one interception. One of the things that Jake talked about early was not making those bad interceptions, and he didn't really have, you know, he just had that one interception. They add that on to one fumble for only two turnovers. Knights defense, KCU Knights defense took the ball away four times, two fumble recoveries and two interceptions. One of those interceptions was a big play in the game, as we were just talking about with Jake, that ends up in an 80-yard interception return for a touchdown and contributes to that 51 points. They did a good job. You know, another thing that I think Jake will circle is that 10 in the penalty column, 10 penalties for 106 yards. You know, next week I'm sure he's going to want to cut that down, too many post-snap, pre-snap penalties. And you're going to have a hold and things here and there, but the unsportsmanlike maybe and some of the early jumps are things that they're going to concentrate on, try to cut that number down, 10 penalties for 106 yards. On the other side, St. Andrews had 7 for only 47 yards. The big thing defensively that you really got to like, that you really love to see, is they held St. Andrews to 2 out of 13 on third down. That's huge, only 15%. That's right, that's a huge statistic, and you're going to win a bunch of games. Even though they gained 500 yards on offense, only converting 2 of 13 on third down, that's getting them off the field. They did go for it 9 times in a game, which is a crazy number.
Yeah.
Converted 4 of those, but just not enough, as KCU was just too good offensively. They were 6 out of 13 themselves, were just under 50% on third down and 1-1 on fourth down. They completed, you asked about this earlier, but Kentucky Christian in the red zone 5 times. 5 touchdowns. Yeah, that's being efficient. That's a great stat. That's taking advantage of your opportunities. So a great day for the Kentucky Christian offense. The defense also contributes with 6 points of their own on the big interception return, gets them off the field on third down, and really a good day for the Knights.
Absolutely. Coach, I appreciate you. This has been a fun one.
Absolutely.
Yes, sir. Hey, a big shout-out and a thank you to Lane and Jeff and Dwayne back at the studio, and that's going to do it for our broadcast, Coach. For Coach Brent Terry, I'm Chauncey Griffith. I always say good night and God bless. It's not nighttime yet, so good day and God bless.
've been listening to Kentucky Christian University football on the Cool Hit Sports Network and Cool TV. This KCU football game has been brought to you by Kentucky Christian University, River Cities Builders, A&A Porta Potties, Trey Hermanos Nunez,